are the experts to turn to when you're injured and you can't work. Ketch's Law handles more workers' compensation cases than any other law firm in Massachusetts, winning the largest verdicts in the Commonwealth in 2020 and 2021. So let them get to work on your case. There's no fee unless you win. Go to ketcheslaw.com to schedule your free consultation today.
Get a great offer on the stylish HR-V or the Honda Civic, which Car and Driver called fun to drive. Honda, the brand name, Kelley Blue Book's KBB.com best value brand for 2023. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Civic or HR-V.
See dealer for financing details. Exclusive SI and Type R Car and Driver January 2023 based on 2023 brand image awards from Kelley Blue Book. Visit KBB.com for more information.
The only place to hear the game, the Sports Hub.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the 98.5 The Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network.
This is Boston's most listened to sports station. Boston's home for sports. 98.5 Sports Hub, a Beasley Media Group station.
Time for Beers and Me to take a look around the National Hockey League. Let's begin off the ice. The National Hockey League is reportedly working to move the Coyotes from Arizona to Utah. Here's Coyotes head coach Andre Tourigny from Thursday on Wolf and Luke on Arizona Sports Radio.
That is a lot of impact because our player loves to play in Phoenix. They love to play for each other. I think that is that has a huge impact. But I will tell you where it has the most impact is we have 31 staff members who don't have a contract for next year. Those guys have family. Some are divorced. Some their kids are in Phoenix and they're divorced. Some have a wife or a partner who has a job who now they will have to take a decision. Those kind of things are real. That's real. That's emotion. That's real life.
Yeah, this is a tough one. I don't think it's a surprise in terms of what's been going on in Arizona. I mean, now you start to hear even more things coming out. More things coming to the surface. You know, playing in that arena, nice college rink, but it's certainly not it's not an NHL rink, and it's not a remedy for what needed to be done. And you know, they're trying to get land other places to try to build, and it's going to be a few years away if they do get it. They're not closing the door on getting a team in the future, but for now, going to Utah, this is massive. I mean, look, for us that travel, we know what a great place that Arizona is in terms of, I think it's a great place to live. A lot of people love living there, playing there. I can attest that Utah's a fantastic place as well because I spent, a season there and how great that place is. But, yeah, just like Tourigny says, it's for families. Everybody's got a different situation, and it's not just a player that's being impacted or a coach that's being impacted. It's families and it's personnel and it's people that work for the team and how they move forward. It's a seismic event right now for the league. We see teams relocating, but it hasn't happened in a while. And we saw expansion, but we haven't seen the relocation in several years now. Was Atlanta to Winnipeg the last one? Maybe I could be wrong on that, but they kind of had an idea of that. They kind of have an inkling of that. This is coming late in the season. They're still playing games, and then it's going to be a quick turnaround to get up and running next year in Salt Lake City.
Let's see if we can get to some of the early finals. The Rangers victorious early today over the Islanders.
Here comes Trocheck. Picks up the puck across the blue line. Moving down the right side slowly. Cuts to the slot. Trocheck shoots and scores! Rangers win!
Yeah, Rangers come out on top. Now, the Rangers have 112 points. That puts them 5 points up on the Bruins. They only have one game remaining. The Bruins could mathematically catch them, but most likely won't. And for the New York Islanders, more importantly, Islanders now have played 80 games. They've got 90 points. That puts them 5 points up on the teams that are chasing in the playoff push, including Washington, Detroit, and Philadelphia. Philadelphia is 87 points, so only 3 points behind. It's just because of the games going on this afternoon, but Philadelphia only has one game remaining, so they can't catch them.
Jason Robertson sealed the division title for the Dallas Stars.
Pavelski tried to snap one through on a seam pass for Robertson. Haskinen, Robertson, Ben, back to Robertson. Robertson scores!
Yeah, they would win this game 3-1 over Seattle. Heiskanen, by the way, a goal and two assists in that game, defenseman for the Dallas Stars.
The Jets pounded the Avalanche.
That hit Lekkonen in front of the goal, and Avalanche cannot buy a break right now. Jets all over them today. And two men in. It's Adam Lowry. Shot scores! Lowry, five-hole, his second, and the Jets are ahead by a converted touchdown, 7-0.
That would be the final. Winnipeg over Colorado in Colorado, 7-0. Monahan, two goals and an assist. Morrissey, a goal and two assists. Hellebuck, 30 saves. And if my math is correct, Judd, when I look at it, Winnipeg and Colorado are locked in. They will play each other in round one. It just depends on who's going to finish second, who's going to finish third. Winnipeg right now has two more points than Colorado. They do have the tiebreaker as well. Both teams with two games remaining.
In a moment, we'll have our conversation with the head coach, Jim Montgomery. We're getting you set for the Bruins and Penguins here in the Steel City on the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
This month, treat yourself to the gift of quick, convenient vehicle maintenance. Valvoline Instant Oil Change will have your full-service oil change complete in just about 15 minutes without you ever needing to leave your driver's seat. While you're comfortable, add additional services like a radiator flush, tire rotation, battery replacement, and so much more. Stop by whenever it's best for you because no appointment is ever needed. Visit NewEnglandOilChange.com for 15% off your entire service at Valvoline Instant Oil Change. Now open in Raynham, Reading, and Braintree.
Bosch tools are built for workers. Bosch's powerful hammer drill has kickback control to help work go more smoothly when you need it. The 2-in-1 impact driver and wrench quickly changes between bits and sockets, so you only need one tool instead of two. And the X-Lock grinder switches wheels up to 5 times faster than standard grinders. Bosch tools take care of the job and you. Bosch Tools, what hard workers deserve. Learn more at BoschTools.com.
Hey, it's Charlie Coyle. I've teamed with WellPoint, formerly Unicare, Franklin Sports, and 98.5 The Sports Hub for face-offs for first responders to encourage more Massachusetts youth to engage in physical activity to improve their mental health. Playing sports helps reduce stress, create social connections, teaches teamwork, and builds self-esteem. For every Boston face-off win, WellPoint donates $15 up to $15,000 to provide street hockey equipment from Franklin Sports. Franklin Sports will provide $1,000 gift cards to 15 youth hockey programs in Massachusetts. Learn more now at 98.5 The Sports sportshub.com/first responders.
Have damaged pipes at your home or office? Don't dig it. Line it with a lining solution from Drains by James. DrainsByJames.com.
Drains by James. They give a poop about your pipes.
Tito's Handmade Vodka on game day? Pour me in, coach. From a seat in the stands to the best seat on the couch, root for your favorite team with your favorite team spirit. No matter who's on your roster, lineup, or lucky jersey, make Tito's your first-round bottle pick. Whose house? Tito's house. Find cocktail recipes for every fan at Tito'sVodka.com. 40% alcohol by volume, namely 80 proof, crafted to be savored responsibly.
Felger and Naz, afternoons 2 to 6 on the Sports Hub.
Welcome back to the Duncan Bruins pregame show. Time to bring in the head coach of the Bruins, Jim Montgomery, which is brought to you by Clinton Savings Bank. Do you know a youth coach that's had a positive impact on their community? Enter that coach to win a $500 Dick's Sporting Goods gift card for their team. Nominate your coach and get full details at ClintonSavings.com/coach. Member FDIC, member DIF. Monty, heading into the last road trip of the regular season, the Bruins are 22-8-9 away from TD Garden. In the big picture, what's made your team such a good group on the road?
I think the number one thing is that we stay in games because we manage games well. We don't beat ourselves. We have real good goaltending, and we have players that really care about coming out on the right side of results.
Heading into this game against the Penguins, it looks like you're going to shift some of your combinations up front. What's it going to look like here tonight?
Well, we got Pat Maroon coming in the lineup, so he's going to go play with Boakfist. I like the idea of, I thought Boakfist and Brazo played really well, so I think that, you know, the big rig is a similar player to Brazo, and then you got the speed of Lauko on the other side, so I like that. That's a fast, heavy, and also abrasive group, and then we're putting Johnny Beecher on left wing with and moving back Geeky to center to give us real good balance up the middle, but also speed and size on that third line.
I know you're a guy who likes to change things a lot during the regular season, but when it comes to some of the looks or the experimentation, are you almost done with that here in the regular season?
Well, again, there's always the game within the game. I think we're really, or I am, really settled on who's going to primarily play with who the rest of the year. But there's always going to be guys that you need to, because of the game within the game. Some guys are on top of their game. They've earned more ice because they're playing so well. And then you have the other side of it where, you know, guys maybe are not having the best game and they need to be dropped down a bit.
When it comes to Patrick Maroon, who's going to step in your lineup here for the first time tonight, how do his intangibles on the ice, in the room, affect the team?
Well, I don't know yet, right? I just think that he's a calming effect. He's brings swagger and confidence, and that's what I'm excited to watch and learn from.
As he jumps into the bottom six, how important is it here down the stretch, or even looking ahead to the playoffs, that you have the right mix on whoever is populating those third or fourth lines?
Well, it's always important that you have four lines that can go out and play against anybody and be able to manage a game and create some momentum.
Monty, you've said consistently process is important for the Bruins. Are you putting any importance on winning the division?
No, we haven't really talked about the division. Obviously, you want to win your division. First place matters, you know, to have home ice. But we're really just focused on our process. And, you know, there's some things that we think allow us to get to our identity and just being consistent with delivering those messages.
Whether it's here tonight or the game that you have at the tail end of this road trip in Washington, you're going to face some desperate teams. Is that hard to match?
You know, sometimes, you know, you're playing desperate teams, they're tight because everything matters so much just to get in the dance. We know we're in the dance, so we can afford to be a little bit looser. But at the same time, we're trying to fine tune our process and be ready to be hard against come next week.
Last thing, when it comes to the process, what elements will be important tonight against the Penguins?
Well, you know, the Penguins do a really good job with their gaps, with their defensemen and their reloads. So breaking pucks out, playing in behind them, those are things that, you know, it doesn't matter who you're playing, but against the Penguins, it's really important.
Good luck tonight, Monty.
Thank you.
That's the head coach, Jim Montgomery. Stay with us. The Bruins and the Penguins are coming up next.
This is Boston Bruins Hockey, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V, available at your local New England Honda dealers.
Cross to Esposito, a shot.
Are brought to you by Duncan, VA New England, Granite City Electric GCE Nitrate, Valvoline Instant Oil Change, Tito's Handmade Vodka, Live Nation, Nissan, Avidia Bank, the Fuel Rewards Program from Shell, Peerless Boilers, Coors Banquet, the Peterson School, Clinton Savings Bank, and by Shaw's and Star Market.
Save it, Gilbert! A dandy! A dandy! Great run save by Jamie!
Backhand, it'll save Thomas!
Jeremy Swayman celebrates his first NHL shutout!
And by Ketch's Law, TD Bank, Ticketmaster, Town Fair Tire, your New England Ford dealers, Charles D. Sheehy, UMass Lowell, Timberline Construction, Service Credit Union, Bosch Tools, and by DraftKings Sportsbook.
Back to Orr. Put in. Fire!
Stanley Cup final for the third time this decade.
Now, here's John Surratt and Bob Beers.
Tonight, the Boston Bruins will match up against the Pittsburgh Penguins for the final time during the regular season. These two teams have split the first two meetings, both of them taking place in Boston. Your keys.
Well, as good as well as Pittsburgh has played defensively this year, I mean, Tristan Jarry had part of the year, then he got hurt, and he's lost his starting spot to Nedeljkovic. Nedeljkovic has played 11 straight games. And there were some leaks the other day, not just from him, but from the way that they played defensively. And Erik Karlsson, a guy that's being honored right now for his 1,000th game, which is tonight. And there's a lot of tributes going on the Jumbotron. But they can be had defensively, I think. I don't care what the numbers say. I think you can get to them defensively. Give Crosby all the credit in the world for the way that he's played at every zone this season, and he's put this team on his back and gotten them into contention. But it's ironic, it's funny, because of the games that are going on right now, there's a chance that Pittsburgh could be out of the playoffs starting, and when this game starts, or they are actually out of the playoffs technically right now based on points, and Detroit is winning right now. They're over Toronto 4-1. That game is only in the second period, but that could be three teams that jump ahead of Pittsburgh before this game even starts. So there's a lot of things going on at the bottom of the standings and a lot of things that can still happen between now and the end of the season, which is only a few days away.
The keys to the game are brought to you by Town Fair Tire. For the guaranteed lowest prices on tires, go to Town Fair Tire, because nobody beats Town Fair Tire. Nobody. We'll drop the puck here at the PPG Paints Arena when we return on the 98.5 The Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
Hey, it's Maz for DraftKings, an action-packed fight card taking place in Las Vegas for UFC 300. And the DraftKings Sportsbook, the official sports betting partner of UFC, is giving you a chance to get in on the action with a knockout offer for every fight fan. New customers, if you bet on any UFC 300 bout, you can turn $5 into $150 instantly in bonus bets. From the much-anticipated title fight between Pereira versus Hill to the exciting undercard bouts, DraftKings is giving new customers a shot to rack up some bonus bets. Again, just lay down some action on any UFC 300 bet, and you'll get the bonus bets back instantly, no matter what. Just download the DraftKings Sportsbook app. The code is SportsHub, and again, new customers can bet $5 to get $150 instantly in bonus bets.
Hope is here. 800-327-5050 or gamblinghelplinema.org. Must be 21 plus. Play it smart from the start. GameSenseMA.com. Visit the president in Massachusetts. Bonus bets expire 168 hours after issuance. Eligibility and deposit restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.draftkings.com/MMA.
Hi, I'm Patrice Bergeron. This season, Avidia Bank and I are continuing the Assist for Kids program. For every Boston assist, Avidia donates $50 up to $30,000 to help Metro West families pay for youth hockey. I would also donate $7,000 for a total of $37,000 to help even more families. Get details now at avidiabank.com/teambergeron. Avidia Bank, honest to goodness, member FDIC, member DIF.
Sports don't get any tougher than hockey, and trucks don't get any tougher than Ford F-Series, F-150, and Super Duty. The trucks that move mountains also move parade floats and snowmobiles. With that versatility, it's no wonder Ford F-Series is the number one selling pickup for 47 years straight. Visit buyfordnow.com for great offers. Your New England Ford dealers, a proud partner of your Boston Bruins. Sales claim based on 1977 to 2023 CY total sales.
The home of the bees, the Sports Hub.
The first 5 minutes are presented by your New England Ford dealers. Now during Truck Month, get a great deal on Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks for 47 years straight.
As together with one voice, we sing the Star Spangled Banner.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets were bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home.
People here in Pittsburgh fired up as the Penguins make their push to the playoffs. We get set for the opening faceoff between the Penguins and Bruins. We take a look at our starting lineups here today. In goal for Pittsburgh, Alex Nedeljkovic. On defense, the pairing of Marcus Pettersson. And playing in game number 1,000, Erik Karlsson. Up front, Drew O'Connor, Sidney Crosby, and Brian Rust. For the Bruins, it's Linus Ullmark in goal. Hampus Lindholm, Charlie McAvoy, your defenseman, and up front, Brad Marchand, Charlie Coyle, and Jake DeBrusk. Starting lineup is brought to you by DraftKings Sportsbook. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app and use code SportsHub. New customers can bet $5 to get $150 instantly in bonus bets only with DraftKings Sportsbook with code SPORTSHUB. The crown is yours.
Bruins working right to left here in this opening stanza, where the white road jerseys, black numbers and letters outlined in centennial gold. The Penguins in their home black jerseys in honor of Harry Sinden. That's yellow that they have on the sleeves, the numbers, and the letters.
Yeah, they like to say black and gold here. I don't go with it. Maybe the Steelers and the Pirates, but not the Penguins.
They drop the puck. Bruins win the faceoff, and we're underway. Bruins and Penguins for the final time in the regular season. Marchand dips around a check over the line right side, into the right circle. Set it out in front, deflected just wide.
That was Brust going to the net. He got inside position there on Carlson. Nice little play from Marchand through the neutral zone and then the pass in front.
Brust put back on this line after playing on a third line here recently in the last couple of games. The puck sent out in front and Allmark blockered it back into traffic. Along the near side, the Bruins chip it out to the neutral zone. Here's Coyle.
Yeah, I like this move, and not only on this line for DeBrusk, but also the top power play unit. I think it's important to try to get Jake DeBrusk on the score sheet here heading into the playoffs. Doesn't mean he can't turn it on when the playoffs start, but I do think it's important. He's an important part of this team to get him going offensively. And I know he does good things when he's not scoring, but he needs to score.
Patrick Maroon on the ice for the first time as a Bruin. Right circle, it's fired by Letang, headed over the net by Allmark. High slot sent toward the front of the net, and Allmark the stop, and the rebound swept over to the far side. And the Bruins club it out to the neutral zone.
You know, I watched the Islanders play earlier today. I know they lost that game in a shootout to the New York Rangers, but that's a team that's fighting for a playoff spot. They played hard. You can see why they're winning some games here recently. I expect the same thing from Pittsburgh here today.
Oh, Noah Dobson, by the way, for the Islanders again today. Puck sent to the far corner of the Bruins zone. We played a minute and a half. We're scoreless. Right point, Jack St. Ivany will send it just wide of the right post. Back of the net, it's Shattenkirk.
Yeah, a couple new faces on the back end, right, for Pittsburgh.
Both rookies. Now in the slot here, Zacha back in. He sent it just wide of the far post as he elevated it. Back of the net now. Here's Zacha. Rotates to the far side. Chipped behind the net by Carlo, who had moved up into the right circle.
Zacha got position on Shea that time. A little spinorama backhand.
And we've got an icing call here on the Penguins.
That's another icing call sponsored by Tito's Handmade Vodka. Enjoy the game with a glass of Tito's on ice. Tito's cocktail of the week is the Tito's Transfusion. For tonight's recipe, go to 98.5thesportshub.com.
Ryan Shea, a native of Milton, Massachusetts, played a little bit at BC High, 4 years at Northeastern, making his NHL debut this year with the Pittsburgh Penguins. Originally a fourth-round pick of the Blackhawks, but he never signed with the team. Penguins win the draw, can't flip it out, held in by Frederick. Bruins chip it into the right corner. St. Ivany bumped it back of the net. And now rotating up the right side, here's Shea. He'll twist back between the rings in his own zone as Mike Sullivan makes some changes in his ninth season here in Pittsburgh. Now Shea deals a puck to the far side, and it's drilled by Carlson out to center ice. The Bruins denied at the red line. 17 and a half left here on the first, and we're scoreless. Along the near side, Bemstrom bats it in. Shattenkirk relays it to his partner, McAvoy, and the Bruins will fling it deep. Nedeljkovic stopped it, gave it away. Marchand into the right circle. Marchand up top, peak, fires, and it's deflected wide.
Nedeljkovic has battled. He's battled hard. He's played well. He's been Alex Lyon from last year, right, playing with the Florida Panthers, willing his team into the playoffs when Bobrovsky was struggling, but
Peak shoots just wide. He was looking for a tip in the slot.
He's played a lot of hockey here recently and given up a bunch of goals the other day. Didn't have much help from some of his D, though.
Along the near side, it's flipped by Shattenkirk and out to center ice, and the Bruins regroup back in their own zone. 16:44 left here on the first and scoreless. Now Marchand brings it in, pushed from behind by Rust. In the near corner, DeBrusk scoops it up. He'll throw it around to the far side. Drew O'Connor, goals in each of his last two. Saucers across the neutral zone to Crosby, and the Penguins are offside.
Drew O'Connor's been a nice find for this Pittsburgh Penguins team. He's played some good hockey for them, filling in. He's playing on the top line right now with Crosby and Rust. That allows them to spread things out because Bunting has been a good player for them since coming over at the trade deadline. Yes, they lost Gensel in that trade, But Michael Bunting has scored some big goals for this team and has played some good hockey playing alongside Malkin and Raquel.
Bunting, 5 goals, 14 points in 18 games. The other thing he's been a disciplined player.
Well, that was his problem in the playoffs, right, with Toronto.
Last year he finished with more than, just even in the regular season, he finished with more than 100 penalty minutes.
Well, that's
with
okay.
Penguins.
I can take that, but
he's got
to be done at the right time.
Bruins threaded ahead. Over the line is Heinen. The former Penguin shoots just wide.
That puck was up on edge. Nice pass from McAvoy into the middle that time.
Here's Pastrnak near hash, sitting on 47 goals, fifth in the league. And it's drilled by the Penguins all the way down. And Letang guilty of icing.
I think, you know, talking about Pastrnak, we haven't talked much about him today, but he had a rough one the other day. And he wasn't alone, you know, against Carolina in that one. It's going to happen from time to time, but think he just didn't have anything really in the tank. And the thing about Pastrnak is when he's had those types of games, he usually bounces back and bounces back in a big way.
Pastrnak registered only one shot on goal the other day against Carolina.
Oh, yeah, two attempts, if I'm not mistaken.
And I think we've got a hand pass out in the neutral zone. 15:46 left here in the first, and Brad Marchand was not credited with a shot on net in that game.
They both struggled. And just watching the first couple shifts here for Marchand, he's flying right now. They've had 3 days off, right? Played Tuesday. We knew it. There was going to be a time where teams had to catch up in terms of games played. Well, it's been a while since they've had 3 days off between games, and see if they can take advantage of it.
Bruins fire the puck to the near corner in the Penguins' end. Here's Maroon. Protects it. Shoveled it to the near side. Boqvist. Left of the cage. Centered out in front. Deflected. And Nedeljkovic the stop. The rebound is available. Nedeljkovic then dives on it. And then Boqvist gets roughed up. And Patrick Maroon is going to work his way into the pile.
Yeah, that was Maroon on the opportunity there. What nice pass from Boqvist. Maroon helps keep it alive, and then Maroon goes to the net, and a hard pass from this left wing, the base of the left wing circle, to Maroon in front, who makes himself available. And what a great chance he has. That stop by Nedeljkovic, he can't cover it up. And then it's Lauko digging for it. He gets a shot at the rebound, or at least a chip at the rebound. Nedeljkovic is known kind of as a battler. He battles right there to keep that puck out of the net. Well, I mean, Maroon that close to having his first as a Bruin.
Maroon this year with the Minnesota, 4 goals, 16 points in 49 games. The Penguins win the draw. They're number one in the league in faceoff win percentage. They chip it on net, gloved by Allmark. 15:21 left here in the first and scoreless.
Maroon can be a nice compliment for Boqvist. Boqvist is a guy that's skilled, fast. You know, is his play along the wall his strong point? No. Which is just the opposite for Maroon. And you hope that Lauko can be a compliment on that line as well. So Maroon playing the off wing. Maroon can win pucks, win battles, and make plays down low.
Patterson up top. It's rifled high and wide by Carlson. Back of the Bruins net, it's Malkin.
Bunting with some contact there.
Puck bounced on net, and a nice play made by Allmark. The Red Sox may want to take a look at him as he stopped that skipping puck just wide of the right post.
Yeah, Bunting had some contact there with Allmark on the initial shot that came through. He was around the front of the net. That time, Allmark able to track that puck as it changed direction. Got tipped down off the ice and then back up again.
15:08 left here in the first and scoreless. Allmark eighth in the league in goals against, third now in save percentage. Right point, it's Carlson. Fires, blocked, rebound the other way. It's a race for the puck. Heinen has it picked off by Carlson, who scooted back.
I don't think Heinen recognized it immediately because he had a chance to get up the ice, but Carlson pretty good at getting back that time.
Bruins rip it in. Nedeljkovic stopped it back of the net, looks and feeds to the far corner. Here's Carlson playing in his first season here in Pittsburgh. Fired it out to center ice. The Bruins throw it in front of the penalty boxes near side. Here's O'Connor, shoots. Allmark kicked out the right leg.
Dangerous chance. O'Connor into the slot that time. Left shot, kind of moving to his left.
Bruins turn it over. Here's Rust over the line, far side. His shot deflected over the glass. 14:27 left here in the first and scoreless.
Good pace to start this game, right? We figure that the Penguins will be into it right off the hop, the way that they're playing, what's at stake for them. You know, they're looking around the league. They're checking out everything that went on. Capitals just jumped in front of them in the standings. Flyers jumped in front of them in the standings. Right now, Detroit leading Toronto. late second period, or at least halfway through the game. They're up 4-2, so there's a lot of things that can happen here for the Penguins, as well as they played. Find themselves on the outside looking in without a W here.
Faceoff in the far circle, the Bruins, and last year, the Penguins essentially controlled their destiny, but lost games late to two non-playoff teams, the Blackhawks and the Blue Jackets.
I mean, two teams that you just cannot lose to, and it led to a number of changes with Pittsburgh as well, not only Carlson coming in, but changes in the front office. And
Ron Hextall was sent out. Kyle Dubas was brought in. Back of the Bruins net. Held in at the right point. Letang's shot kicked over to the far side. Dribbled by the former Bruin Riley Smith over to the near wall. Here's Letang. Letang protects. Flings it up top. A little room. Joseph, his shot steered aside by Allmark. The Bruins trying to drive it up the middle. Marchand was all by himself.
Yeah, trying to get behind the D that time was Marchand.
Now Lindholm protects the puck. He'll skate it up the left side. Right wing feed out at center ice. DeBrusk played it off his skate. He'll backhand it deep. Both teams change. 13 and a half left here on the first and scoreless. Here's Letang. He'll wheel up the middle. 50 points in the season. He'll fling it into the far corner. Now Shattenkirk gets inside position trying to strip the puck. Radim Zahorna shoveled it over to the far side. Left point now. Shea to his partner St. Ivany. His shot kicked out by Omar. Rebound along the near side. Jeff Carter in his 19th season in the league.
Good
pumped
example
it over to the far side.
Right there, Judd. You know, getting used to playing a system. Maroon was playing almost man-on-man that time. Lauko had to adjust.
Boquist, left circle, sent it to Maroon, and his shot was blocked. And the puck is bounced back into the Bruins zone. Quick changes by the Penguins. Puck is drilled to the right of Nedeljkovic, and we have icing.
So out high, Pittsburgh walking the line as a defenseman moving from right to left, and Maroon was kind of chasing. He was actually letting Lauko play him kind of man-to-man, but that, you know, that's not the way the Bruins play it, so it might take him a few games to kind of get used to things. He's a smart player, especially in the offensive zone, but defensively you got to kind of, you know, learn the system, learn it on the fly.
Loved his line maybe a day ago when he was asked about his timing. He said, I'm sure my timing is going to be horse bleep.
Oh, yeah.
Over the line, right side, here's Malkin.
He's not too concerned. I mean, he's won three cups. He can say whatever he wants.
Well, and that was the other thing that he pointed out, Piercy, is this puck is squirted over to the far side of the Bruins zone. Back of the net, Malkin. Right point, Carlson shoots. Hit a leg into the right corner. Raquel stripped of the puck. And we're going to have a penalty here. It's going to be a cross check. Carlo now having words with Raquel. 12:08 left here in the first. We're scoreless, and we'll take a timeout. Here on the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CRV at your local New England Honda dealers.
So here, if you're a plumber, pipe fitter, or in the piping trades, then you need to call my friends at Charles D. Sheehy for any of your piping product needs. Sheehy is proud to work with the region's best life science, biotech, and pharma contractors to help them deliver their projects on time and within budget. Sheehy is driven to deliver.
Hey, it's Charlie Coyle. I've teamed with Unicare, Franklin Sports, and 98.5 The Sports Hub to encourage more Massachusetts youth to improve their mental health by engaging in physical activity. Franklin Sports will donate $15,000 in athletic equipment to help kids get out and play. Get details at 98.5thesportshub.com/firstresponders.
Do you know a youth sports coach that has had a positive impact on their community? Nominate them now at ClintonSavings.com to enter them to win a $500 Dick's Sporting Goods gift card to help support their home team. For complete rules, visit ClintonSavings.com. Member FDIC, member DIF, NMLS number 422081.
Join New Hampshire Liquor and Wine Outlet on a West Coast rendezvous during our Pacific Pour Savings event. Now through April 28th, save 20% off the purchase of 12 or more bottles of wine from Washington, Oregon, and California. Whether you save the bold flavors of Washington, the crisp elegance of Oregon, or the sun-kissed richness of California, now is your chance to uncork the savings. For more info, visit liquorandwineoutlets.com. Discount valid on 375 and 750 milliliter size bottles only. Please drink responsibly.
The Peterson School is now hiring for new instructors at all four locations.
Hi, I'm Adam Norcott, an electrical instructor at the Peterson School. I've learned so much from my students and their experiences, and it's made me a better teacher, foreman, and electrician.
Visit petersonschool.com.
Connect with Boston's home for sports online. 98.5thesportshub.com.
The first 5 minutes of tonight's game were brought to you by your New England Ford dealers. Now during Truck Month, get a great deal on Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks for 47 years straight. Morgan Geeky heading to the box for a cross check, so the Penguins get the first power play of the game. We're scoreless. We played about 8 minutes. The Penguins, this is baffling. They are 31st in the league on the power play.
Well, a lot of it was earlier in the year. They went through a spell where they couldn't score. And Geeky was coming in to help out Carlo. It wasn't a hard cross check, but it was enough. You just don't want to give a team like this any life. And no matter what it says on paper, I think it's a dangerous team with a fan advantage.
Absolutely. Look at the names we're going to call. Here's Carlson at the right point. He'll wheel to the high slot. Stick handles and looks. Feeds to Crosby. Back up top. Malkin. High slot. Carlson. Far side. Bunting. And then the puck nearly given away. Marchand with it. He'll feather it all the way down.
It's a long way for Bunting to be away from the net. I would expect him around the front of the net. We got Russ down by the front.
Puck fired in and wide. Allmark drills it himself up left wing, and the Bruins deflect it back into the Penguins' end. Bruins short for another minute 12. The Bruins' penalty kill seventh in the league. Over the line right side is Malkin, driven against the boards by McAvoy. And it's pounded up top. Here's Carlson at the right point. Left it up top for Malkin. He'll wheel to the middle center point. Right point, Carlson shoots, and Allmark the save through traffic. You had Rust and Crosby out in front. Puck sent toward the front of the net. Crosby knotted up, and the Bruins drill it all the way down. 44 seconds left in the Geeky penalty. Scoreless game, 10:49 left here in the first in Pittsburgh. Here's Letang. Dish to the right side, Raquel. Over the red checkered line, he'll blast it in. Far side, it lays at the point for Letang. Rink wide, now to the high slot. Carter shoots over the crossbar. Rebound driven back of the net, near side. The Bruins trying to get to a loose puck. Along the near side, they battle for it. Carter's got it, wings it across. Now to the high slot, here's Carter. Left point, Letang. Stick handles, looks, attacks to the dot, feeds to the far corner. Turning far side, the Penguins have it. And now it's drilled back of the net and over to the near side. Digging away is DeBrusque. 3 seconds left in the Geeky penalty. Bruins trying to battle to get it free. Geeky's out of the penalty box, so the Bruins back to full strength. The Penguins still keep the puck in zone, lose it. The Bruins will head the other way.
Strong penalty kill by the Bruins. Some good clears.
Beecher's shot from the right circle is
really
blocked.
The only shot towards Allmark was from the point.
Zahorna, 6 foot six, rubbed off the puck in the far corner by Shattenkirk, and the Bruins looking to counter. Here's Geeky center circle. Snapped it over the line. Pasternak left circle. Pulls, drag, just poke checked at the last second by Carlson.
Oh, Carlson got a stick. Pasternak looked like he had him beat, but Carlson reaches out to poke that puck away just at the last second.
Puck skied out to the neutral zone by the Penguins. Shattenkirk plays it off the right wing boards, and the Penguins got it. They'll rush back in. Pustinen to the far circle. Zahorna shot partially blocked. Shattenkirk back of the net. Dished it up the left side, and out comes Frederick. Frederick over the red line. He'll brush it deep. The Bruins making some changes. Nedeljkovic stops it. Leaves it back of the net. St. Ivany from Manhattan Beach, California. Up the right side to Raquel. He enters just into the Bruins zone on the right side. Bounced it into the far corner. Raquel worked his way around a pick. Shea shoots, and it's gloved by Allmark. And we'll take a timeout. 8:51 left here in the first. Bruins nothing. Penguins nothing. On the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
It's Ford Truck Month. Are you ready? And we're celebrating 47 years as the best-selling trucks in America. Once-a-year offers on Ford F-Series. Featuring the new 2024 Ford F-150 and Ford Super Duty, the 2024 North American Truck of the Year. Celebrate with us, America. This is Ford Truck Month, based on 1977 to 2023 industry reported total sales.
It's only human to be passionate, loyal, and all in when it comes to the Bruins. And it's only human to expect the same from your bank. And just like every season, TD will be there for all the wins, losses, and memorable moments. Best of luck this season. TD Bank, the bank of the Boston Bruins. Member FDIC, TD Bank NA.
Download free nugs. Just add the Wendy's app to your phone and get an offer for a free 10-piece with purchase. Ah, yep,
the training nugs again.
One app, all the...
Ow! Wendy's.
Limited time at participating Wendy's. New Year's only. Account registration required. Terms apply.
At Milton Cat, our business is supporting your business with quality equipment, parts, and service. Visit MiltonCat.com today to learn why we've been the Northeast's trusted equipment dealer for over 60 years.
If it's big and heavy and gotta go, contact the pros at Removal Pro. Removal Pro of New England specializes in the removal and installation of oil tanks of all shapes and sizes. Removal Pro will also take any size boiler, water heater, or furnace. Visit oilremovalpro.com.
The Celtics play here at the Sports Hub.
Service Credit Union is teamed with Bruins defenseman Charlie McAvoy for defending New England's heroes. Service donates $100 for every block shot and $1,000 for every shutout to pay for heart and cancer screenings for New England police and firefighters. Learn more now at servicecu.org/73. Congratulations to the Denver Pioneers. They won the NCAA title, shutting out Boston College, the number one team in the nation, 2-0. That's Jim Montgomery's old team. Along the far side, Bunting protects.
Well, wait a second. He coached them.
Yes.
Okay.
He played at Maine,
yes.
Coached the team. All right, got to make that clear. Almost
won,
had to.
He won national championships as a player at Maine and as a coach at Denver.
You can open the fine jar if you want.
Along
the near side, here's
clarify.
Coyle. Left point. Shoots. Deflected back of the net. DeBrusk has it. He'll rotate to the far corner. Joseph trying to contain him. DeBrusk played it to Coyle. Banked it up top. Here's McAvoy. Goals in each of his last two. Shoots. Blocked. Rebound to Grizzlick. He'll fling it over to the far side. Back of the net. Marchand sitting on 400 goals. Puck sent over to the near side. Grizzlick tried to pound into the left corner. Cut off by Malkin. And the Penguins will look to exit. Raquel's pass. He leaves it in the near corner for Letang, who didn't originally expect it, but the Bruins were changing.
Letang went to throw a hit on Marchand. Marchand got the better of him that time. Those two have had some pretty good battles.
I didn't see. Was there a bicep flex in there?
No. It was just much like Marchand has done this year. Just play the game.
Carlo knotted up out in front with Rust, and then it's banked out in front by Crosby, and the Bruins able to deny that. Three on two. They rush the other way. Heinen over the line. Flipped into the near circle, grabbed by Zacha. He'll turn on his forehand, banked it up top. Lindholm shoots just wide.
Dalkovich never saw that.
Back of the net, Zacha. Zacha sets up in the office. Draws Pettersson to him. To the right point, now Pasternak flipped it to the far side, away from Rust. Into the slot, Zacha shoots, blocked. Near hash, it's Zacha. He'll chip it to Pasternak. Zacha out in front. Heinen trying to nudge it for Carlo. And the Penguins recover, and they'll fire it back into the Bruins'
end. Terrific setup that time from Pasternak into Zacha in the slot area. Pasternak could have gone to Carlo for the one-timer. Instead, held on to it, moved down the right-wing boards, and then found Zacha out high.
Bruins bounce it to the left into Nedeljkovic. 6.5 minutes remaining here in the first, and we're scoreless. Dug out by Lauko. Trying to bang it up top. The pass never got there. Far side, it's Peak. He has his only goal of the season against the Penguins. It came while he was with the Blue Jackets. Up the right side, Boqvist. Had it stripped. Smith brings it back in. Boqvist gets it back.
Yeah,
he'll bounce it to the point.
Don't think you want to give that puck to Boqvist right there. He's got a man, O'Connor, right in his face as soon as he gets that puck.
Here's Boqvist. Threw a stick check. Fed to the far side. Oh, that was a very... very kind change that was allowed. Back of the net now, Maroon protects. Swings right circle. Peak shot it out in front. Nedeljkovic, a stick save. Chopped over to the near side. Here's Riley Smith, who won a Stanley Cup last year with Vegas. He'll delay. Gets over the line. That looked like it was offside. Puck given away near side. Shattenkirk. A backhand dish to Beecher. He'll skate it out to center ice. We'll never know. Geeky over the line right side.
Pulled a groin trying to stay onside.
Far hash. It's held in at the point for a second by the Bruins. They'll chip it into the near corner. Geeky is chasing. And Letang rockets one up the middle, and it bounces back into the Bruins zone. Grizzlick, a button hook along the near side, trying to exit the puck. Second attempt. Stick handles his way through some traffic. And now here's Geeky. Almost lost his balance. Snapped it into the right corner. Just about 5 minutes to go here in the first, and we're scoreless in Pittsburgh. Now McAvoy waiting. Bruins will tag up and start to change as the puck is sent in deep. Now Joseph, far circle of his own zone, stops. Drills it up the left side, deflected to the Bruins zone, sent the other way in transition. Coyle over the line to Marchand left circle. He'll turn away, lost an edge. And now rushing the other way is Bunting over the line with Malkin. Has a guy driving, dropped the puck awkwardly to Raquel. It's sent out in front, deflected. And Omark had to scramble back just in case. High slot, Carlson fires, gloved by Omark. He couldn't hold it. And the Bruins will head the other way.
Great recovery by the Bruins, though, to get back on that play. Bunting and Marchand all locked up in front of the penalty box.
Here's Zacha. He'll wheel over the line right side. Marchand trying to escape Bunting. Now Grizzlick lost his footing. Knifes the puck to Pastrnak. Pulls, drags, backhand. Couldn't get it off. Near circle.
Penalty coming up to the Penguins.
It's going to be for a chop. 4:09 left here on the first. Bruins and Penguins are scoreless. On the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
The Honda you want is here. Drive in the moment. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 2.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Passport or Ridgeline and a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Pilot.
See dealer for financing details.
Hey, DQ fans, behold the DQ Freezer, holding all of the DQ Blizzard flavors of the past. Now picture the DQ Freezer to bring fan-fave Frosted Animal Cookie and legendary Brownie Batter back for its 20th anniversary, only at participating DQ locations. Happy Taste Good.
Town Fair Tire has the area's largest selection of Toyo tires. Sells them all at the guaranteed lowest price, offers more free services for life than anywhere else, and Town Fair has well over 100 locations throughout New England and New York. The area's largest inventory of Toyo tires at the guaranteed lowest price, more locations, and the most free services for life. So for your next set of Toyo tires, remember, nobody beats Town Fair Tire. Nobody.
Name brands at discount prices. Town Fair Tire.
Hi, I'm Charlie McAvoy. Service Credit Union and I are defending New England's heroes. Service will donate up to $100,000 this season to cover heart and cancer screenings for New England's fire and police. Get details at servicecu.org/73.
The Honda you want is here. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Accord and a 2.9% APR on a 2024 CR-V. So hurry into your local Honda dealer today.
See dealer for financing details.
Listen live. Check out our podcast with the 98.5 The Sports Hub app.
The Bruins' first power play is brought to you by Bosch Tools. Engineered for efficiency, comfort, and ease, Bosch Tools are built to keep workers going at full strength. Bosch Tools, what hard workers deserve. Evgeny Malkin, the guilty party. Bruins with their first power play of the game, scoreless. 4:09 left here on the first. Faceoff will be in the left circle of the Penguins' end. The Bruins' man advantage has dipped to 13th in the league, 2 for its last 27.
Yeah, that last play, the Penguins fans weren't happy. I think Bunting and Marchand, I think you could have tried to make a case maybe either one of them getting a penalty, but they elected not to give either one a penalty. And it ended up being Malkin on the... There's a slash or hook there on Pastrnak going to the net.
Bruins rocket the puck ahead. It's deflected off to Bruska just inside the line. And then it's golfed out to center ice by Letang. And the Bruins grab it. Penguins will start to make some changes on their penalty kill. They're 11th in the league on the penalty kill. Up the middle, Zacha to Pastrnak over the red line. Enters over the line right side, then lost it. And scooting the other way is O'Connor. Watched by McAvoy, far corner. Hits the brakes. Stripped of the puck by Marchand, and the Bruins trying to work their way ahead. Now DeBrusque speeds his way in, high slot. Right point now sent to the high slot. Marchand kicks to the stick, pulls around to check. Couldn't get around the last guy, Shea.
Shea looked like he was beaten, but he stayed with him.
Left point, McAvoy, rink wide, Pastrnak back to McAvoy. Wrister, Nedeljkovic the save, the rebound off the post.
Pastrnak put that off the post.
Back of the net, it's centered. Zacha drive, Nedeljkovic trying to block her to side. Back of the net, they still joust for it.
Nedeljkovic just battling right now, a couple great opportunities.
High slot, it's McAvoy to the far circle. Marchand shoots, Nedeljkovic the save, and he covers up. And then St. Ivan, he got involved behind the net. A little pushing with Jake DeBrusque. The linesmen separate those guys.
DeBrusque with some good speed entering the zone, moves this puck over, and then they get the puck into the middle. And Pastrnak on the rebound off the McAvoy shot, backhand, chips this puck up over the top of the glove side of Nedeljkovic, but it goes off the post and out. I was just doing some numbers there, Judd. For Pastrnak, he's continued to score goals, right? But on the power play, one goal in his last 31 games.
Faceoff in the far circle in the Penguins' end. Bruins on the man advantage, another 30 seconds.
That was a good power play right there for that unit. Now we get Pat Maroon in front of the net and on this second unit. See how that looks for the last 20 seconds and not much time for them.
Penguins rip it all the way down. 19 seconds left now on the power play. 2:25 left here on a scoreless first. Here's Heinen over the line. He'll drive it in to the far side. Pettersson, he'll flip it up left wing, and it's brushed all the way down.
Got to get a forward off now, get two defensemen out there, which they do. Heinen goes off.
And Malkin is now out of the box. So each team 0 for 1 on the power play. Lindholm motored through a check, then lost it, and it's drilled.
That's
looking for Crosby, and he couldn't accept the pass. Otherwise, he was gone.
Yeah, not crazy about that decision to make that pass right there, because Lindholm's got a man right in front of him, and nobody, and the Bruins are getting a line change. Crosby's behind everybody if that pass connects.
Here's Carlson. He'll wheel up the left side with speed. His pass played off a skate by Smith. Sent it to nobody in particular along the near side.
Moving.
Bruins bank it up right wing all the way down, and instead, the Bruins ice the puck.
Well, Bruins hockey is presented by Timberline Construction, providing truly exceptional service in construction management, pre-construction, design build, and due diligence support. Learn more at TimberlineConstruction.com. Timberline Construction, exceptional, no exceptions.
Minute 35 left here on the first and scoreless. Faceoff far circle in the Bruins' end. Frederick's going to take it against Crosby. And Frederick won it. And they're going to redo it. And Frederick is giving it to the linesman right now. The two centermen get set. Nobody was kicked out. Now they reset everybody. And Frederick wins it again. Here's McAvoy. Shuttles it back of the net. The puck rolling on edge. Lindholm. He'll blast it up the left side. The Bruins cap it to the red line. Frederick will feed it deep and head off to change. Now along the near side in the Penguins' end, here's Carlson up right wing. Cuts toward the middle. The back checking to Brusk stripped him of the puck, and the Penguins bring it in offside.
Yeah, they got an argument, though. I think the Brusk actually brought that puck back into the zone after he stripped him of the puck in the neutral zone. That's what Brian Rust is trying to say. That shouldn't have been offside. So I don't know if he's... He's still barking at the linesman there.
1:13 left here in the first and scoreless.
Close.
Here's Letang. Feeds it across the red line. Drilled in by Joseph. Sent around to the far side. Pastrnak sent it to the middle. Kicked out to the neutral zone by Zacha. He got spun around and down. And now the Bruins apparently unable to keep it in. The linesman, while sitting on top of the bench boards, was able to call that offside.
Between the Pipes is sponsored by Charles D. Sheehy. If you're in the piping trades, you need to call Charles D. Sheehy, Boston's premier piping and mechanical product supplier. Sheehy is driven to deliver. Between the Pipes for the Pittsburgh Penguins here tonight, Alex Nedeljkovic, 11 straight starts for him. And for the Bruins, it's Linus Ullmark.
He was signed to be the backup Nedeljkovic. He signed a one-year, $1.5 million deal. Along the near side, it's Coyle, left of the cage, protects, then he lost an edge.
It's happened a couple times with Bruins in that offensive zone, huh? Marchand earlier.
Not in the neutral zone to Brust, knocked a puck out of midair, attacks, left circle to the dot, backhand, and Nedeljkovic got a piece of it with the poke check.
I don't know if that puck ever got to him.
Now Coyle, backhand, rejected before it got to Nedeljkovic. And it's banged back into the Bruins' end. Carlo's on it. Penguins changing.
Joseph might have made that play defensively before DeBrusque could get to the net.
Omark fell down with nobody around him as the puck is sent up the middle and out to center ice. Peek will drill it in. He heads Bruins, off to change.
Bruins goalie that had that happen to him a few times. It was pretty good for the Bruins.
I don't know if Omark had burgers before the game. Up the right side is Carlson slowly, and that's going to do it for the opening 20 minutes. As it's ripped down the ice by Pettersson. So we're through one. Bruins nothing, Penguins nothing. Pearson and I We'll bring you back for the first intermission. We'll have your NHL Plays of the Week coming up next on the 98.5 The Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
Dropping a new kind of energy. Introducing Sparked Energy by Dunkin'. It's energy for the fun of it. Available in two full-on delicious flavors, Berry Burst and Peach Sunshine. It's what you need when your afternoon needs you to get going. A revitalizing burst of caffeine, vitamins, and minerals gives you the energy to turn the fun up to 11. True story. Drop by or order ahead on the Dunkin' app today. Fruit flavor contains 0% fruit juice. Caffeine from caffeine and guarana. Participation may vary. Limited time offer.
The Honda you want is here. Drive in the moment with the Road Trip Ready Accord Hybrid and CR-V Hybrid from Honda. So bring on the weekend getaways. Bring on the far destinations. Bring on the memories. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Accord Hybrid or CR-V Hybrid.
See dealer for financing details.
Hi, this is Jake DeBrusk, and I'm excited to team up with the Shaw's and Star Market Foundation and 98.5 The Sports Hub once again for Feeding the Puck for Families. Every time me or one of my teammates feeds the puck this season to help score a goal, the Shaw's and Star Market Foundation Nourishing Neighbors Initiative will donate funds to end hunger here in our local communities. Since its inception, Nourishing Neighbors has raised more than $250 million across the country to ensure our neighbors have the nutrition needed to thrive. Locally, the Shaw's and Star Market Foundation will be enabling a donation of $100 every time we feed the puck for a goal to the Greater Boston Food Bank to help end hunger, up to $50,000. To learn more about Feed the Puck for Families, visit 985thesportshub.com/feedthepuck.
The Bruins are back on the ice, and this season you can be in the stands to experience it all live. Shop a wide variety of seats for every match from Ticketmaster, the official ticketing partner of the Boston Bruins and the NHL. And make sure you don't miss a single moment. And rest assured, if your plans change, Ticketmaster has you covered so you can securely sell your seats to other fans with just a few taps. Get tickets now at Ticketmaster.com/Bruins.
Boston Bruins fans, save big on home game days. Save 25 cents per gallon on Shell V-Power Nitro Plus Premium Gasoline with the Fuel Rewards Program. Download the app. Start saving today. Game on.
Waiting for your electrical supplies during the day or sitting in traffic is for the birds. Use the GCE Night Train from Granite City Electric and get access to over $50 million in local inventory with a free guaranteed overnight delivery of your electrical supplies anywhere in New England. So avoid wasting time waiting in line and sitting in traffic. Order by 5 p.m. and you'll have your materials the next morning by 6 a.m. guaranteed. Visit GCENightTrain.com to get on board the GCE Night Train today. Granite City Electric, proud partner of the Boston Bruins Radio Network.
The home of the Revs, the Sports Hub.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the 98.5 The Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network.
Boston, this is Boston's most listened to sports station. Boston's home for sports. 98.5 The Sports Hub, Beasley Media Group Station.
So far tonight, the Bruins have won 8 faceoffs at Wellpoint, formerly Unicare. Charlie Coyle and Franklin Sports will donate $120 to provide Franklin Sports street hockey equipment to 15 Massachusetts towns to help kids get out and play to improve their mental health. So far, they've donated $5,670 on their way to $15,000. Get started on your path to whole health now at wellpoint.unicare.com. We've hit the first intermission here at the PPG Paints Arena in Pittsburgh. Bruins and the Penguins are scoreless. This week, Austin Matthews inched closer to the 70-goal mark. Alexander Ovechkin made more history. The Islanders surged into third place in the Metro, and it's anyone's guess who's going to take the second and final wildcard spot in the Eastern Conference. Here are your NHL Plays of the Week.
Scramble in behind. Malkin a pass right circle. Carlson, here he is. Fires. That one go in. It was just wide from Raquel off a lightning stick.
Malkin's redirect hit the post, went to Raquel, who had a wide open net in the swing of the miss.
Touch pass. Loose in front. Bunting. He scores. He scores. Michael Bunting puts the Penguins back on top. They would not be
his side, Ekman Larson. Gave it away. Boqvist wheels ahead with a step left circle. Shoots. He scores! Jesper Boqvist cranked it in off an air post. An overtime game winner. The Boston Bruins sweep the regular season series against the Panthers. And they're going to take a 5-point lead in the Atlantic Division with 4 games left. Your final here today, Bruins 3, Panthers 2.
Predators get it to Ryan O'Reilly. Now behind the net, they set it up. Back to O'Reilly in front. He fan on the one-timer. Here, Palmieri shooting for the empty net. Bullseye! Second straight game with an empty net goal for Kyle Palmieri.
Marner gets it back to Matthews in front of the net for McKay, who scores! Jake McKay is the hero. Setting him up, but it was Alphonse and Gaston trying to get off the ice. This is the big play.
Through the right circle, back door, quick shot. Oh, just missing their rebound. They score! Kyle Palmieri makes it goals in 3 straight games, and the Long Island native has made it 3-0 Islanders.
Back out for Sherrod at center. Go cross ice. It bounces off a Sider. The Capitals got momentum here. Here comes Ovechkin. Left side. Shooting. He scores with 7.2 seconds to go. It's his 30th goal of the season. And Alex Ovechkin is the first player in National Hockey League history to get 30 or more goals in 18 seasons. And it is a gigantic goal here in Detroit. It's 2-0 Washington.
Roding sends it into the corner. Knocked down. Chance. Scores. Austin Matthews, 67. And he's gone past Dave Keon on the all-time link list. Here's Tyler Bertuzzi. Back to Domi. Takes a look. Matthews scores.
Puck 2-on-1. Noah Cates, he's got a man in front. Hathaway. Cates goes in front. Took the shot. He scores! Noah Cates buries it on the far side, stick side on Jonathan Quick. His 6th goal of the year. That's 3 in the last 5 games for Noah Cates, and Philadelphia has a 3-goal lead.
Islanders have it left half boards. Brock Nelson in Montreal ice dances to the high slot. Nelly loads the gun to Palmieri right in the net. Sharp angle shoot. He scores! Goals in 4 straight games. He's got an overtime winner tonight as New York takes it 3-2, and they are out to mob the Long Island native in a sea of blue jerseys.
Erik Karlsson already with an overtime game winner this year in Vancouver. Behind the back for Raquel, driving toward the net, charging toward the goal, threw it off the side of the cage. Crosby wins the battle. He's got the puck. Crosby sets it up up high. Karlsson blasts. He scores!
The Penguins could not hold a 5-3 third period lead in that game, but ultimately skill won out, putting the Penguins for the time being in a wild card spot and pushing the Red Wings 1 point back. But again, things are changing by the minute. Scoring summary at the end of one. Neither team able to tally. Each team 0-for-1 on the power play. Shots on goal in favor of the Penguins, 13-9. I'll update the out-of-town NHL board when we return on the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
Sports don't get any tougher than hockey, and trucks don't get any tougher than Ford F-Series, F-150, and Super Duty. The trucks that move mountains also move parade floats and snowmobiles. With that versatility, it's no wonder Ford F-Series is the number one selling pickup for 47 years straight. Visit buyfordnow.com for great offers. Your New England Ford dealers, a proud partner of your Boston Bruins. Sales claim based on 1977 to 2023 CY total sales.
Hey, it's Patrice Bergeron. When I was young, my parents worked hard to get me everything I needed to play youth hockey. They sacrificed their time and money so I could play the game I loved. That's why I've teamed up with Avida Bank again this season for Assist for Kids to help Metro West families pay for youth hockey. For every Boston assist, Avida donates $50 up to $30,000, and I will donate $7,000 to make it $37,000 to help more kids. Avida Bank, honest to goodness, member FDIC, member DIF.
98.5 The Sports Hub and the Bruins Radio Network welcome the following new partners. Shell and the Shell Fuel Rewards Program. Bruins fans save big on home game days. Save 25 cents per gallon on Shell V-Power Nitro Plus Premium Gasoline with the Fuel Rewards Program. Download the app and join the Fuel Rewards Program. And Nissan. At Nissan, they make cars that thrill. Experience the thrill for yourself today. Shop NissanUSA.com. From the home of the Bruins, thank you for joining our winning team.
Have damaged pipes at your home or office? Don't dig it. Line it with a lining solution from Drains by James. DrainsByJames.com.
Drains by James. They give a poop about your pipes.
Hi, I'm Matt Reddy, Vice President of Professional Firefighters of Massachusetts and a cancer survivor. Thanks to finding my cancer early. The conditions we work under and the chemicals we're exposed to make cancer the leading cause of death for firefighters. The PFFM is aggressively pursuing programs to detect cancer early, increasing the rate of survival. Now, Service Credit Union and Boston Defender Charlie McAvoy are joining the battle, generously donating $50,000 to purchase early detection cancer screenings that will identify over 50 types of cancer. Learn more now at servicecu.org/73.
The only place to hear the game, the Sports Hub.
Half an 11-game plans for the Bruins 24-25 season are officially on sale. Certain plans also include the club's centennial game, which is expected to be held as a part of the 24-25 regular season on December 1st at TD Garden. For more information, visit bostonbruins.com/gameplans. Scoreless here in Pittsburgh, Bruins and Penguins, as we take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. Earlier today, it was the Rangers winning it 3-2 in the shootout over the Islanders. Stars 3 and the Kraken 1. The Jets shut out the Avalanche in Denver 7-0. Sam Reinhart, the winner in overtime. Panthers 3 and the Sabres 2. The Flyers shut out the Devils 1-0. The Capitals got a couple of goals from Sonny Milano and beat the Lightning 4-2. In progress, Canadiens over the Senators 3-2 at the end of 2. The Leafs have rallied to tie the Red Wings at 4. They're at the end of 2 periods there. Predators 3 and the Blue Jackets 1. And a little bit later tonight, the Canucks are in Edmonton. Kings host the Ducks. Wild and Sharks in the Bay Area. In a moment, we'll hear from Jacob Lauko. On the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
Construction is a proud partner of the Boston Bruins Radio Network, and just like the pros, success in the commercial construction industry requires a strong, smart team with no exceptions commitment to excellence. Trust Timberline with your next commercial project. TimberlineConstruction.com. Timberline Construction. Exceptional. No exceptions.
Stay up to date with all the Boston Bruins injuries during the Ketch's Law Injury Report on the Boston Bruins Radio Network. Ketch's Law, the official law firm of the Boston Bruins. They've won over $2 billion for their clients. When you're injured and can't work, turn to Ketch's Law. There's no fee unless you win. Go to ketcheslaw.com to schedule your free consultation today.
It was an epic block party. Until the speakers blew. Luckily, my new Nissan Sentra was just up the street. With its Bose audio system, I was able to get the party going again. Yeah. And turn it all the way up.
Drive the Nissan Sentra. Now, get a low $229 per month lease for 36 months on the 2024 Nissan Sentra. Shop at your local Nissan store or at NissanUSA.com.
Well-qualified lessees. 2024 Sentra S front-wheel drive. $25.99 initial payment excludes tax, title, and license. Disposition fee due at lease end. Take from new dealer stock. Call 1-888-858-8319 for offer details. Ends 4-30-24.
Bosch tools are built for workers. Bosch's powerful hammer drill has kickback control to help work go more smoothly when you need it. The 2-in-1 impact driver and wrench quickly changes between bits and sockets, so you only need one tool instead of two. And the X-Lock grinder switches wheels up to 5 times faster than standard grinders. Bosch tools take care of the job and you. Bosch Tools, what hard workers deserve. Learn more at BoschTools.com.
The Stanley Cup Playoffs Bracket Challenge presented by Betway is back. And now it's time to take your shot. Face off against family and friends. And take aim at predicting this year's playoffs. Whether you're pulling for the Panthers, going big on the Blue Shirts, or seeing stars all the way, who do you think hoists the cup this year? Sign up today for a chance to win exclusive prizes at NHL.com/bracket.
Download free nugs. Just add the Wendy's app to your phone and get an offer for a free 10-piece with purchase. Ah, yep, it's raining nugs again. One app, all the... Ow! Wendy's!
Limited time at participating Wendy's. New Year's is only. Account registration required. Terms apply.
Hockey season means it's Peerless Boiler season. Now is the perfect time to replace your old boiler and water heater with a new Peerless Boiler and Pavilion tankless water heater. Don't wait. Act now. Go to PeerlessBoilers.com for a dealer near you. Remember, Peerless Boilers, the world's best-built boilers.
Felger and Naz, afternoons 2 to 6 on the Sports Hub.
Welcome back to the first intermission in Pittsburgh. The Bruins and the Penguins are scoreless. Our first intermission interview is sponsored by TD Bank. We're joined downstairs by Bruins winger Jacob Lauko. Jacob, you're playing against a pretty desperate team in the Penguins tonight. Were the Bruins able to match some of that intensity in the first period?
I mean, we obviously know that they're trying to make a push for playoffs and they desperately need to win, so we're just trying to be focused from the start and like try to match it. They came out strong like we expected, but I still think we can be better and like doing better jobs in different parts of the game.
I guess with that in particular, where do you think the Bruins can be better as you look ahead to the second?
I mean, we need to protect our net a little bit better because they had a lot of rebounds. Linus made a few great saves, so we gotta be tighter and stronger in our D zone and like be better in transition, because I think we're not doing the good job in that, and it's gonna be our goal for next period.
Last thing, I know it's only 20 minutes, but how was it playing with Patrick Maroon on your line?
I mean, like, you obviously, you can obviously notice him because he's a big boy and he hangs on a puck. He's good and he's good on the walls. He can make plays around the net. So, yeah, obviously, like, we talk about it, like, what we want to do. And, yeah, he's really good around the net. He had a couple of chances and made a couple of great plays. So it's a good thing. It's a good to play with him.
Thanks, Jacob.
Yeah.
It's only human to be passionate, loyal, and all in when it comes to the Bruins, and it's only human to expect the same from your bank. And just like every season, TD will be here for all the wins, losses, and memorable moments. TD Bank, the bank of the Boston Bruins, member FDIC, TD Bank, N.A. All teams back on the ice. We're moments away from starting the second period. The Bruins working left to right.
I think a good pace first period for both teams, right? A couple mistakes, but not many. Well played. The intensity level was there. You figured that was going to be true for the Penguins, who are just riding on a high right now in the way that they're playing. But I like the pace. I mean, you know, you just talked to Lauko and says, you know, be a little bit better around the front of the net. Can always hope for that. And Pittsburgh had a power play where they had a couple of shots taken from the point. But I think all in all, Bruins had some good opportunities. Pastrnak hit the post. Maroon had a great chance. And the Bruins were rounded offensively, which I think you can do against Pittsburgh.
Zacha in for the draw against Crosby. Pavel Zacha one goal away from 20 on the season. It would be his second straight 20-goal campaign.
We've got to get into our trivia with Sidney Crosby, Chuck.
Ah. That was about moving into 10th all-time in NHL scoring history.
Think about that, 10th all-time, and still going strong.
I'll take it one step further. Here's Heinen. He'll drag it back in the net. Can you imagine, as it's fired by Zacha and shrugged off by Nedeljkovic, he's missed a lot of time due to some injuries. He had some serious injuries.
A little earlier in his career, yeah, concussion stuff. And
so imagine if he were healthy, where would he be on that list now?
I think you can say that with a lot of the guys on the list, though, too. You know, you go through your career, if you play that long, you're bound to hit some injuries, right?
Here's Pastrnak, the Bruins race up at the line right side. Pastrnak, he had some chances right in the net, lost it to Carlson. Far side held in by the Bruins. Zacken on the slot. Back pass. And Lindholm shot deflected just wide. Nedeljkovic may have gotten it with the stick. And the puck is chiseled back into the Bruins end along the near side. McAvoy trying to escape Bunting, who attempted to hook him. And then the puck driven all the way down. We have icing here on the Bruins.
It's another icing call sponsored by Tito's Handmade Vodka. Enjoy the game with a glass of Tito's on ice. Tito's cocktail of the week is the Tito's Transfusion. For tonight's recipe, go to 98.5thesportshub.com.
Oh, that could be on the list tomorrow. 18:58 left here in the second. We're scoreless. The Bruins head to Washington after this.
Why wait?
Face off in the near circle, the Bruins end.
I mean, you can wait till after the game. I'm
just okay.
All right.
Near side, Eller. And the puck is chipped over to the far side by Pustinen. There are some old school guys who back in the day. Along the near side, Eller swings it out in front, and Hallmark squared up.
One of your favorites, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I got a picture of him. That's Harry Carey. Over the line right side, DeBrusk. He'll bank it into the far circle.
Bruins were not happy in the first period. Bunting, or maybe it was even in this period earlier, Bunting did a flyby and took the feet out of Linus Hallmark. I think Hallmark may have helped it a little bit, but Bruins players not happy with Bunting as he skated by the bench. It was first period, actually.
Frederick swallowed up as he crossed the line at the high slot, and it's shoveled out to the neutral zone. The Bruins get it back at the red line, looking to re-engage. Here's Geeky. He'll fling it to the far corner. He won a Calder Cup when Nedeljkovic playing in Charlotte, the Carolina system. And the Penguins now will exit the puck. Here's
got a D caught up ice.
Slowly over the line, far side. It's set toward the front of the net, and Allmark skillfully deflects it over the near corner glass. 17:52 left here in the second, and we're scoreless.
All right, Judd, top nine all-time scorers.
Gretzky. Gretzky's got to be on there, obviously.
Well, he's number one.
Howe.
He's number four.
Lemieux.
Yeah, he's number eight.
Marcel Dion.
Yeah, he's number six.
Faceoff in the far circle in the Bruins end. 17:52 left here in the second and scoreless. Okay, so we're looking for the other nine because Crosby's 10.
Well, you're looking for two, three, five.
Jágr.
Yeah, he's two.
Puck kicked into the right corner in the Penguins end. We got another icing. I think they're doing this on purpose. Oh.
Three, five, seven, and nine you're looking for.
17:43 left here in the second. We're scoreless, and I'm stalling.
It's all right. You got time.
Is Steve Yzerman on the list?
He is. He is.
Okay.
He's seven.
Near point now, Pettersson. It swung to the far side, poked out in front. McAvoy had a stick in the way, and he muscles free from Malkin, yeah, who glared at the referee. I don't know what about.
He was either looking to see if the referee's going to raise his arm to call him for a penalty.
McAvoy or Malkin? Wow. Three on two the other way. Over the line right side is Carlson.
With Malkin, you never know.
Sent over to the near side. Malkin banked it up to the right point. Rust shoots, and he airmails it over the crossbar. And the Bruins able to tap it out to the neutral zone. We played about 3 minutes here in Pittsburgh in the second period. We're still scoreless. All right, I'm still down a couple of guys now. I'm trying to think.
Give yourself some time.
Trying to remember how many I have. I have six.
I'll let you know.
Okay.
Stick to calling the game.
Far side, Zacha. I have a hard enough time with that. Right side in the neutral zone, Carlo has to reach back for it. Plays it to Pastrnak, who kissed one off the post in the first. Now here's Crosby, closed on by Lindholm, and a little help from Heinen, and he'll bounce one back into the Penguins' end. Puck banged along the near side. Right corner, Zacha. Joe Sakic on the list.
Yes, he is.
So that's seven.
Number nine. You're missing two.
Oh. Shattenkirk.
Missing three and five, and one of them's obvious, the other one is not.
Mark Messier. Yeah, over the line, high slot, Pastrnak tees it up, off the post, a rebound! Nedeljkovic reaches back, and he snares it in the blue paint. That was close.
He's had two posts in this game so far. We talked about him. Wasn't crazy about the way that he played last game. Wanted to come back here today with a much better effort and much better game plan. And he rips that one off the post. Got some open space through the neutral zone. And, I mean, he winds up old-time slapper with Pettersson. The defenseman tried to use him as a screen. He rips it right off the post, and it somehow stays out. He had a post on a rebound chance in the first period.
Faceoff in the right circle, the Penguins in. Coyle will dig in for the draw against Eller. And the Penguins able to win it free. Back of the net, Carlson fired it around to the far side. It's tipped out to center ice. The Bruins go to Marchand, right wing at the red line. Cuts to the center circle and wrists it into the far corner. And the Penguins will play it up the right side all the way down on net. Hallmark sets it up for Peak. Peak faked a pass, then drilled it up the middle. DeBrusque got it to the blue line of the Penguins' end, but no further. Now Peak, a nice play as Eller tried to thread a pass to the far circle. Marchand knotted up with Eller. Puck into the slot, sent right of the net, and the pass to Pustin in a little bit too far in front of him. Bruins will wheel the other way. Coyle hustles over the line to the high slot. Marchand, his wrister deflected behind the Penguins' net. Back of the net, now to the far corner, Marchand. Wedged free by Carter. Along the far side, Bemstrom. Can he dig it free? Marchand ripped it around to the near side. McAvoy had it just hop by him and out to center ice. Geeky delays and deals it in. Puck sent around to the far corner. Left point, Grizzly. Fired it to the near side. Too far for Geeky. Geeky has it hop by him along the near side. And then Frederick steps up and throws his shoulder into Smith. Bruins will send the puck over the line right side to Beecher. Hits the brakes in the right corner, to the right circle, looks across, fan on his wrist shot. And out at center right, McAvoy's got it. He'll fire it up the middle. Here's Frederick.
That all starts with the physical play of Frederick there in the neutral zone that creates the puck for the Bruins. Beecher just, he did everything right until he tried to take that shot or make that pass across, and the puck just jumped off his stick.
Shots are 17-8 in favor of the Penguins. We're scoreless. We played almost 6 minutes here in the second period.
Does it feel that way? Bruins have hit two posts.
They had some good chances near corner. Malkin to Raquel, his shot blocked. Bruins recover the puck along the near side, pump it ahead. Here comes Lauko, gathers some steam, pushed it into the right corner. Back of the net, St. Ivany, set a pick, it's given away. Maroon shoots, sailed it wide. Right point settled by Carlo. Takes a look, flips it to the right corner. Into the slot, intended for Boqvist, chipped away, and out to center ice. I'm going to need some clues on the last guy.
Yeah.
Boqvist fired it up the middle. Lauko rejected at the line. And we have an icing call here on the Penguins.
I couldn't get this guy yesterday either when I was asked the question. But he is a former Penguin.
13:35 left here in the second. We're scoreless. Luke Robitaille?
No. He had the goals.
Ron Francis.
That's it.
Ronnie Francis. He was such a dominant player. Center circle, it's Crosby. Wheels over the line. Cuts to the near circle. Shoots. Partially blocked by McAvoy.
Nice trade by Hartford.
Off the left side, Heinen. Tape to Pastrnak. Flings it across. McAvoy walks in. Shovel it backhand. Nedeljkovic, the stick save.
He lost the handle on it. Maybe one extra move just trying to get away from that poke check. Nice setup, though, for McAvoy coming late.
Pastrnak to the far circle. Heinen, he'll back it off. The Penguins play a man-on-man. Grizzlick rips one in the slot. Grabbed by Pastrnak. Turns. Shoots. Blocked. Rebound. Settled by McAvoy. He'll bang it back of the net. It just hopped over Zaka's stick. And it's scooped up by Joseph. An outlet up the right side. Over the line, far wall is Rust, offside. 12:43 left here in the second. We are scoreless here in Pittsburgh on the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CRV at your local New England Honda dealers.
Hey, Zoe here, and if you're a plumber, pipe fitter, or in the piping trades, then you need to call my friends at Charles D. Sheehy for any of your product needs. Sheehy's staff is ready to get you the piping and mechanical products that you need on site and on time. Call today for more information. Sheehy is driven to deliver.
Hey, it's Charlie Coyle. I've teamed with Wellpoint, formerly Unicare, and 98.5 The Sports Hub for face-offs for first responders to let all first responders know it's okay to talk to someone when the job gets to be too much. We also want to let anyone listening to this message know that if you or a loved one are thinking about suicide or need emotional support, the Lifeline Network is available 24/7 to help you. Just text or call 988 and Lifeline will provide you confidential help for free from a skilled, trained crisis worker. There's hope in getting help. Call or text 988 now.
Escape the lows of New England winters with a home equity line of credit from Clinton Savings Bank. Perfect for home improvements, tuition, debt consolidation, and dream vacations. Talk to us today about an introductory annual percentage rate of just 5.99% on our home equity line of credit for the first 6 months. Clinton Savings Bank. Go beyond banking. Call 888-744-4272 for details about credit costs and terms. Some restrictions apply. Offer may be withdrawn at any time. NMLS number 422081. Member FDIC, DIF, and an equal housing lender.
If it's big and heavy and gotta go, contact the pros at Removal Pro. Removal Pro of New England specializes in the removal and installation of oil tanks of all shapes and sizes. Removal Pro will also take any size boiler, water heater, or furnace. Visit oilremovalpro.com.
The home of the bees, the sports hub.
The second period faceoff is sponsored by Wellpoint, formerly Unicare, which is teamed with Charlie Coyle, Massachusetts State and Local Police, the professional firefighters of Massachusetts, and Bruins Radio for face-offs for first responders to encourage first responders to ask for help when the job gets to be too much. Get started on your path to whole health now at wellpoint.unicare.com. Face-off in front of the Penguins bench. And by the way, congratulations to the Bruins general manager, Don Sweeney. Sweeney named the GM of Team Canada for next year's four-nation tournament that's going to take place. It hasn't been officially said. It should be in Toronto and in Boston.
It might be Montreal and Boston, Judd.
Back of the net, Eller. Swings to the far side. Either way, congrats. Puck sent to the front of the net. Pusinen's drive. Got block coming in. The Bruins smack it over to the far side. The Bruins chip it to the middle, and they can't get it out. Here's Eller to the right circle. Attacks to the middle. Left of the net. Around a check. Goes deep into the slot, and the shot is chunked.
Yeah, Carlo forced Eller, at least to his forehand, so he wanted to get that shot away. Carlo stayed with him.
Right circle now, Peak fires, Nedeljkovic to save, they score! Jake DeBrus got the loose, change out in front, pumps it 5-hole, Bruins 1, Penguins nothing.
Yeah, so the Bruins go from not being able to get a puck out and getting outnumbered down towards the net. Carlo makes a good defensive play, however, and makes sure that Eller is not able to get that shot away. And the Bruins come down the other way. Peak ends up with this puck over on the right wing side, in the just below the dot in the right wing circle. He's going to center a pass for Jake DeBrus, who gets a tip on Nedeljkovic. The puck, the initial shot doesn't go in, or the initial tip doesn't go in, but he stays with it, gets his own rebound, and pushes it home.
So the Bruins open the scoring. Penguins taking a long look at this, but I don't believe they're going to challenge for DeBrus. Gets his 19th goal of the season.
Well, they want to see if DeBrus pitchforked this puck through, but I don't think he did. I think the puck actually got through on its own before. And he did kind of push it, though, push the pad.
But it was available.
Yes.
Between the wickets.
Yep.
Here's Grizzlick over the line left side to the far circle. Shoots, rebound, nice goal! Next shift, Pavel Zacha gets another juicy pork chop and drills it in the top near corner. 2-0 Bruins.
Boy, was it ever. Shot from Grizzlick from the left wing side as he jumps up into the play. Bruins win the faceoff. A little D to D, move this puck up the ice. Grizzlick gets some ice, takes it, gets moving up the left wing side. Penguins give him the line, takes the shot. He's outside the dot, above the circle on the left wing side, and he takes this shot. A big rebound coming out for Zacha, who's right in the middle of the ice, and Zacha pounds this one home past the glove-hand side of Nedeljkovic.
That's his 20th of the season, first time he's ever had back-to-back 20-goal campaigns, and it ties his career high in points with 57. Bruins 2, Penguins nothing, 11 and a half remaining here in the second, well, and this place has gone quiet.
Yeah, I said, Judd, earlier this period, we were saying it, Bruins were stuck on 8 shots. They didn't have any shots on goal, but they had a post, had a couple of opportunities. I thought they'd been the better team here in this second period, and finally they break through with a pair.
Joseph flings to the far side. Here's Carlson. Rank wide, Joseph wrists it over the line. Russ is going to have to chase it down at the near hash marks. Carlo got to it. Bruins can't get it out. Sent to the right circle, and the wrister taken in by Omark. O'Connor didn't get a lot on it.
Letang jumped that time. The pass was intended up the left wing for Frederick, but Letang anticipated, got in front of Frederick. Lindholm thought he had a clear pass there, but a nice read by Letang to keep that puck in. But Allmark, another confident save. Fans, hockey season is Peerless Boiler season. Replace your old boiler and water heater with a new Peerless Boiler and Pavilion tankless water heater. Find your local dealer at peerlessboilers.com. And remember, Peerless Boilers, the world's best built boilers.
Along the far side, chiseled ahead by Shattenkirk and out to center ice. 2-0 Bruins. Just under 11 minutes remaining in the second as this puck is swatted over the short glass near side and into the stands. For every goal the Bruins score this season, Tito's Handmade Vodka will donate $100 to the Cam Neely Foundation, up to $10,000. Jake DeBrusk opened it up at 8:08, is 19th. Pavel Zacha, 14 seconds later, is 20th at 8:22. Near circle of his own zone, Shea. He'll rip it up the left side. It deflects high and over the glass in the near corner into the Zamboni tunnel, and we've got to stop. 10:37 left here in the second. Bruins 2 and the Penguins nothing. For Andrew Peak, he gets the primary assist on the opening goal. That's his second point since coming to the Bruins. Charlie Coyle, the secondary assist. Matt Grizzlick and Charlie McAvoy, the assist on the Zacha strike.
I mean, Peak had a nice pass there to DeBrus. The initial chance could have gone in. Dunkovich fought it off, had that puck bobble around on him, and was really unable to locate it as it was underneath him, and that's where DeBrus pushed it home.
Bruins wristed up the right side.
Here's the rebound, though, if you're a Penguin on you know, the shot from outside the dot, higher than the dot, wrist shot from Grizzlick coming in off the rush.
Here's DeBrus, bangs it back in the net, looking for Marchand. Marchand along the near side, trying to whack the puck free. And the puck is skittered out to the neutral zone. Penguins trying to thread a pass ahead. It's denied at the blue line. The Bruins bank it the other way. And the Penguins get it back just inside their line near side. They'll flip it to the near corner of the Bruins zone. Mike Sullivan wants to make a few changes. 9:59 left here in the second. Bruins 2, Penguins nothing. DeBrusk, a lead pass ahead on right wing, a little too far for Coyle. And
right
jam back.
On the give and go, right idea.
Now far circle of his own zone, Grizzlick wrists it up the left side. DeBrusk tapped it just inside the Penguins line. Jim Montgomery making some changes. Puck sent ahead, Crosby. Over the line right side, here's O'Connor to the right circle. Sent it out in front, they score. Rust with a deflection. And the Penguins on the board, Bruins 2, Penguins 1.
Yeah, the Bruins were trying to get a line change here, weren't able to do it. They get moving up the ice. And it's chipped into the zone. And the Penguins turn it up, get going back the other way. Nice pass through the neutral zone. But Grizzlick kind of gets beat a little bit over on that right wing side by O'Connor as the pass came over to him. Can't recover. And then O'Connor's going to take the puck to the net from the right side and find Rust back door before the Bruins can recover and get back on him. He's got good speed. And he's going to beat everybody up the ice to just chip this puck past the right pad of Allmark. Lone guy back was McAvoy. He couldn't intercept that pass. Heinen can't quite catch up to Rust, but it starts when you get beat at the blue line.
That's the 28th goal of the season for the Pontiac, Michigan native. Now Heinen over the line, high slot. Stick handles to the near point. Now to the right circle. Gets it back. Slings it up top. Pasternak shoots. Nedeljkovic, a blocker save. Far corner, Heinen got drilled on a check by Joseph. And out to center ice it comes. Lindholm turns it through the middle. Pasternak up at the line, high slot. Pasternak, high slot, fires. Nedeljkovic to save. For a second, he looked behind him. It almost snuck inside the right arm as O'Connor gets locked up with Zacha behind the net. 9:01 left here in the second. Bruins 2 and the Penguins 1. On the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
The Honda you want is here. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Civic or HR-V.
So hurry into your local Honda dealer today.
See dealer for financing details. Excludes Civic Si and Type R.
It's only human to be passionate, loyal, and all in when it comes to the Bruins. And it's only human to expect the same from your bank. And just like every season, TD will be there for all the wins, losses, and memorable moments. Best of luck this season. TD Bank, the bank of the Boston Bruins. Member FDIC, TD Bank N.A.
When it comes to getting the guaranteed lowest price on Toyo tires, there's only one place to go, Town Fair Tire. And when it comes to getting more free services for life than anywhere else on Toyo tires, there's only one place to go, Town Fair Tire. So when you're in the market for a new set of Toyo tires, there's only one place to go, because nobody beats a Town Fair Tire deal. Absolutely nobody.
Name brands at discount prices, Town Fair.
Hey, DQ fans, behold the DQ Freezer, holding all of the DQ Blizzard flavors of the past. Now picture the DQ Freezer to bring fan fave Frosted Animal Cookie and legendary Brownie Batter back for its 20th anniversary, only at participating DQ locations. Happy taste good.
The Honda you want is here, so bring on the fun. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Accord Hybrid or CR-V Hybrid. Hurry into your local Honda dealer today.
See dealer for financing details.
Connect with Boston's home for sports online. 98.5thesportshub.com.
Andrew Pink, Charlie Coyle with the assist on the Bruins' opening goal. That's our delivery of the game, delivered by Granite City Electric's TCE Nitrate. Granite City Electric Supply, celebrating 100 years of service to electrical contractors in New England. Visit graniteCityElectric.com to order. Faceoff in the far circle of Penguins' end. Rust from O'Connor and Crosby at 10:27, as the Penguins trailing 2-1 at the 9:01 mark here in the second. Zacha will lean in for the draw. He wins it. Up top, Shattenkirk. Tried to settle a rolling puck. It's banged into the far corner. Pasternak tried to elude the linesman along the far side. And Eller gets to it. He'll swat it up right wing back into the Bruins zone. McAvoy chipped it along the near side. He's out there with Shattenkirk right now. Bruins send it up the far side.
Yeah, offensive zone faceoff. Try something a little different.
Pasternak pushed it into the right corner. Zacha leaned on by
McAvoy.
Carter.
McAvoy goes off. Peak just hopped on.
Pasternak pulls it free. Back of the net. Slings it right circle. Shattenkirk shoots. He scores! Kevin Shattenkirk! With a bullseye in the top far corner. 3-1 Bruins.
I'm telling you, Nedeljkovic has been shaky, right? He's, you know, the big rebound. This is a wrist shot from Shattenkirk that's going to beat him. No traffic in front of the net. It's just one-on-one. And it's not a bomb. Bruins win a battle. Pasternak comes out. He's off to Nedeljkovic's right. But he's behind the goal line, and he sends this pass cross ice out to the right point, and this is... It's a wrist shot from above the dot in the right wing circle that's going to beat Nedeljkovic clean off the. It's a great shot, don't get me wrong, but it's going to beat him clean off the post and in. And we're going to have a goaltending change. He's fought the puck here today. 11 straight games for him. Now it's Tristan Jarry's turn. We'll see what the Penguins do with it.
Jarry, during the offseason, was signed by the new general manager to a five-year, $27 million deal. And he's going to head in for the first time in a long time. Nedeljkovic making his 11th straight start here tonight. Jarry, 19-24-5, a 290 goals against and a 903 save percentage. Faceoff out in the neutral
Frederick
zone.
Frederick giving it to Bunting right now, right off the draw.
Puck bounced in, and Ullmark makes the stop. And he holds. 8:20 left here in the second. 3-1 Bruins.
Fans of IdiaBank and Patrice Bergeron have teamed up again this season for assists for kids. For every Boston assist, they'll donate $50 up to $37,000 to help Metro West youth hockey players pay for hockey. Get details at IdiaBank.com/Team Bergeron. IdiaBank, honest to goodness, member FDIC, member DIF.
For Kevin Shattenkirk, that's his sixth goal of the season and his 23rd point in his 59th game. And the Bruins back up by two here in the second period. Bruins kick it free, fired deep by Frederick. Racing back is Geeky. Shea turns away from him, flipped it up the right side and out to center ice. And it's bounced into the slot of the Bruins zone. It's Pete. cranked it up the far wall.
The Bruins didn't have many options there.
Second effort, got it out to center ice. Frederick lost his footing. Malkin wheels back in, backhands it near circle. Bunting shot it through the goal mouth. Now left point, Shea, high slot. It's Joseph to the near circle. Shea left of the cage, back of the net. Hits the brakes, knocked down. Along the near side, it's flipped up top. Joseph wrists it to the near side. Malkin back up top. Here it comes, and it's sent wide. Frederick's got it. Played it off the wall. He couldn't get it out, however. Gets a little help along the far side. Beecher couldn't free
it. Got to be quicker with your decision there. Got to be faster.
Now right point, Letang to the high slot. Joseph shoots, and it's kicked out in front before it got to Allmark. Bruins backhanded near side. This won't get out. Near corner, it's Rust. Bruins in a little trouble here.
I think you got a couple tired decisions being made right now.
And you got the long change here in the second. Grizzlick tries to trap the puck. Freed by Crosby. Up top it comes. Letang at the right point. Shoots, deflected wide. Allmark was screened. Crosby left of the net. Crosby back of the net. Crosby to the far circle. Slings it into the slot. Back to Crosby at the right point. Crosby, wrister, kicked wide by Letang, who joined the attack. Back of the net, now it's sent into the slot, and Geeky trying to settle it near side. Beecher played it off the wall, couldn't get enough on it to get it out. Rust high slot.
Take
right
the icing.
Point, Letang. Far corner now, Crosby, right hash. Up top, it's Letang. Right of the net, Crosby. Stick handles into the slot, Rust shoots. Blocked out in front.
Got some heavy legs right now. You got to take the icing there and get yourself some.
Frederick
right
picks it off, and he'll chip it back.
But you can't get
out
off.
Of the neutral zone. Bruins get one guy off. Puck rimmed over to the far corner. Boquist is the guy who hopped on. Far side, Eller tripped up. Oh, we're going to have a penalty here on the Bruins.
It's bound to happen.
Jari off of the extra attacker. Near point, Carlson. Near circle, Pettersson. Shoots, blocked. Rebound far side, Malkin. He'll twirl it up top. Flings to the right point, Rust. Now far corner, it's Eller, far hash. Back up top for Rust. 5:37 left here in the second, 3-1 Bruins. Malkin skates over to the right point. Just down to the ice is Crosby. The puck is tapped off a Bruin stick to Crosby. Far side, Beecher. Able to control the puck, and now the Bruins are going shorthanded. With 5:23 remaining in the second, the Bruins on top 3-1 here in Pittsburgh. On the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
Sports don't get any tougher than hockey, and trucks don't get any tougher than Ford F-Series, F-150, and Super Duty. The trucks that move mountains also move parade floats and snowmobiles. With that versatility, it's no wonder Ford F-Series is the number one selling pickup for 47 years straight. Visit buyfordnow.com for great offers. Your New England Ford dealers, a proud partner of your Boston Bruins. Sales claim based on 1977 to 2023 CY total sales.
Download free nugs. Just add the Wendy's app to your phone and get an offer for a free 10-piece with purchase. Ah, yep, it's running nugs again. One app, all the... Ow! Wendy's.
Limited time at participating Wendy's. New users only. Account registration required. Terms apply.
Hi, I'm Tyler Kuhn, Vice President of Marketing and Digital Strategy at Service Credit Union. We are honored to team up with Charlie McAvoy to help defend New England's heroes. This year, we're donating up to $100,000 to cover heart and cancer tests for police and firefighters in New England. Early detection is key, and it's our pleasure to defend those who defend us. To learn more, visit servicecu.org/73.
Boston Bruins fans, save big on home game days. Save 25 cents per gallon on Shell V-Power Nitro Plus Premium Gasoline with the Fuel Rewards Program. Download the app. Start saving today. Game on.
The Celtics play here at the Sports Hub.
So all that zone time for the Penguins and the Bruins' inability to clear leads to a Pittsburgh power play. Jesper Boquist off two for tripping. A
couple ways to look at that one, Judd. Nothing got to the net, so they kept everything on the outside. They blocked a shot or two. They blocked a pass. But they had three opportunities to clear. One was earlier in the shift. Peak really didn't have much of an angle. Tried to go up the boards with it. That was kept in. Grizzlick tried to make a backhand pass up the boards. That was kept in. And then Beecher, you know, take the icing. He had time and space there. Take the icing. At least you get a little bit of a rest while you wait for the referee to go down and get the puck, or the linesman go down and get the puck, and come back and drop it. I know it's not a guarantee, but, I mean.
Marchand right of the net, out in front. He scores! A short-handed goal for Marchand. That's 4-0-1, and the Bruins on top, 4-1.
Well, a great move by Marchand to finish this thing off. Lindholm's able to carry this puck up the ice. He's going to throw it down the ice. Now it's Coyle going to work. Jari goes back to play it, sends it around the boards. Carlson doesn't go get it, and Coyle picks it up and finds a wide-open Marchand out in front of the net. Just terrible coverage by the Penguins here. Lazy, lazy coverage by the Penguins on this situation. And Marchand is wide open in front. Mike Sullivan makes a quick change and gets that top unit off the ice. And Marchand makes the move from forehand to, or excuse me, backhand to forehand and slides it five hole. I mean, Jari tries to go around the boards with it. Carlson doesn't go get it. Nobody for the Penguins is back covering anybody.
Near point. Wow. Here's Letang. Left it up top for Smith. Letang center point. Letang stick handles and looks to Smith. Back up top, Letang. Right circle, Raquel shoots, deflected, and Omark made the save. That puck got deflected, and he retrieves the rebound.
I mean, there's still quite a bit of time on this power play, and that was a quick hook. When you look at it on the replay, you see three Penguins up near the blue line. And I don't know, Carlson must have thought he had support over on the wall, because he never even made an attempt to go get it. Coyle just skated over, picked it up, and threw it to a wide-open Marchand.
For Brad Marchand, that's his 36th career shorthanded goal. It ties him for eighth in league history with Sergei Fedorov. Again, these are the things that he's going to put on his resume that at the end of his career will make him Hall of Fame worthy. Far side. It's sent by Carter off the stick and over the glass.
You know, I don't want to dwell on it, but you got to go back to the Bruins and that shift they had in their own zone. And like I said, I thought they defended well because they were exhausted. Heavy legs. But if Frederick had a chance, he could have iced it. He tried a soft chip out of the zone. He got out of the zone. The problem is second period, it's such a long change. Nobody could get off. Only one guy could get off. And then Beecher had an opportunity to clear. He's got to ice the puck there, be strong on that, and live to fight another day.
They score. The puck sent out in front. It's deflected by Bunting, and it's squeezed by Omark at the near post. And the Penguins have tallied on the power play. It's the Bruins 4 and the Penguins 2.
So that top unit gets back out there, and they atone for it. Sorry to be talking over you there, Judd. And it's Bunting who chips this one home on the pass from below the goal line. Not sure how this one squeaks through. Neither is Allmark, as he looks behind him, surprised that this one's got past him. Wasn't much going on. Didn't look very dangerous at all. Yeah, I mean, Allmark thinks he's got the short side post covered. Bunting, all he does is chop at this puck off the pass from Malkin, and Allmark reached with his right hand to try to maybe block that pass out to Bunting, but it squeaks through.
All the goals here in the game have come in this period. We still have another 4 minutes and 8 seconds of it. Off the draw, here's Boqvist. He'll flip it into the right corner. Bruins will make some changes. Back of the net, Boqvist. Bangs it to Maroon. Up top, Lindholm. Fires. And Jari the save on in relief of Nedeljkovic, who got yanked this period. Coming the other way, O'Connor wanted to set it up. And it's Carlson who drags it in, pumps it around to the far side. Back of the net, Carlo. Now the puck is squeezed up the middle. Here's Maroon, the big rig chugging ahead. Over the line, left side, Pasternak. Maroon chasing back of the net. And it's rimmed over to the near side. Here's O'Connor. He'll knuckle it to the left of the Bruins net. Allmark plays it around the boards. Pasternak got a piece of it. The puck was rolling. And Raquel keeps it in. Far side, Malkin. Up top, here it comes. And the shot was blocked. Near corner, the Penguins retrieve. Left point, Bunting. Shoots, deflected in the air. Gloved by Allmark. And he holds with 3:09 left here in the second. Bruins 4 and the Penguins 2.
Well, Ketch's Law, the official law firm of the Boston Bruins, has won over $2 billion for their clients. When you're injured and can't work, turn to Ketch's Law. There's no fee unless you win. Go to ketcheslaw.com to schedule your free consultation today.
A couple other Brad Marchand notes. With that shorthanded goal, that puts him one goal away from matching Rick Middleton for fourth all-time in Bruins history in goal scoring. And tonight he ties Wayne Cashman for sixth all-time in games played as a Bruin. The next guy he's going to catch, he's going to have to wait till the next regular season. That's David Krejci. But he's only a handful of games away from him. Marchand playing in 10:27 tonight. Krejci played 10:32. Here's Joseph up the left side over the red line. He'll fling it into the far corner. Penguins changing. Grizzlick with it. He'll slide behind the net. Bruins up 4-2 with 2:30 left in the second. If you're just joining us, 4-1 earlier today, so they jump in front of the Bruins by a point in the Atlantic Division, but the Bruins technically have two games in hand. The Penguins, because they only had a one-point lead in the wildcard race at the start of the day, the teams below them all won. Washington, Philadelphia, and we're still awaiting what's going to happen with the Detroit Red Wings, so the Penguins are no longer in a playoff position.
They're heading into overtime, Detroit is, so they get at least 1 point, but Pittsburgh has the tiebreaker over the Red Wings, but they do tie them in points.
I believe Pittsburgh has the tiebreaker against all of those teams that are involved. The first tiebreaker is regulation wins.
They do.
Geeky will lean in and take the draw in the near circle against Smith, and the Bruins win it. Fire it behind the net. Here's Heinen on his forehand. He'll lob it into the neutral zone. Lauko chases. Far side, he gets locked up with Shea. Geeky comes in to help. 2 minutes to go here in the second. 4-2 Bruins. Puck shoveled back of the net. St. Ivan, he pulled it off the wall. He played 2 years at Yale and then finished up with 2 years at Boston College. Near corner, Shattenkirk crashes in. He has one of the four goals tonight for the Bruins. Bruins throw it over to the far side. Can't get it out. It's played in the far corner. Geeky, he'll drill it back of the net. Shattenkirk takes a look. Flings it up the right side. Deflected, an area pass looking for Heinen. Ooh, he got tripped up there by Pettersson.
I think he was diving for that puck, I believe.
Over the line, high slot is Rust. Into the slot. Couldn't squeeze off a clean shot as Carlo gapped up on him.
Oh, he's a dangerous player, isn't he?
Yes, he is. And a clutch playoff performer.
Yeah, so is Gensel.
Back of the net. Here's O'Connor, gets a pick. The bank pass up top is grabbed by Boqvist. He'll speed over the line into the far circle. Shoots, and it's shrugged off by Jari, and the rebound goes over the glass.
Boy, Boqvist got Erik Karlsson all tangled up that time. Looked like he was going to go one way, ended up going to the outside. Karlsson able to recover pretty well and keep him to the outside, but a good wrist shot. That's fought off by Jari on that right arm. As Karlsson's trying to angle Boqvist off. You get beat, you angle to a certain spot, you try to keep the guy to the outside, and he did that, but good speed by Boqvist, and Karlsson had to get on his horse to get himself back.
He had to turn and skate forward. Faceoff in the far circle of Penguins end. Off the draw, grabbed by the Penguins. Lines are a little scrambled right now. It's Pasternak, Maroon, and Zacha. Puck sent back of the Penguins' net. It's fired over to the near side. Carter scraped it out to center ice. Pasternak lifts it in. Left of his net. Here's Joseph. Brushed. Maroon dives in. Couldn't get to a loose puck. And the Penguins break the other way with 35 seconds. Eller wanted to enter on left wing, but he had Carter in a step, so he has to back it off. Now high slot of his own zone. Letang banked it ahead.
Too many men. It's too many men.
Says
very
who?
Close.
Near corner, Pasternak. Back of the net. Pasternak tried to wrestle it free. He's had a couple of great chances. Drilled off two posts, one at each end here in the game. Now McAvoy. As he and Malkin come together in the far corner. 2 seconds left. And that's going to do it here for the middle frame. Malkin, and then Pete Malkin's, wants a piece of Malkin.
Malkin hammered him. Malkin's got the lip going. He gets a little pout going, gets upset. He's upset that he lost his stick on McAvoy, took a little shot at him, then took a shot at Peak.
And now
great player, but he can get a little moody sometimes.
Everybody's starting to separate. Some jawing going on still a little bit. So in that second period, the Bruins score four times, the Penguins twice. At the end of two, it's the Bruins 4, Penguins 2. Beersy and I will bring you back for the second intermission in just a moment on the 98.5 The Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
Season means it's Peerless Boiler season. Now is the perfect time to replace your old boiler and water heater with a new Peerless Boiler and Pavilion tankless water heater. Don't wait. Act now. Go to peerlessboilers.com for a dealer near you. Remember, Peerless Boilers, the world's best built boilers.
Hi, this is Jake DeBrusk, and I'm excited to team up with the Shaw's Star Market Foundation and 98.5 The Sports Hub once again for Feeding the Puck for Families. Every time me or one of my teammates feeds the puck this season to help score a goal, the Shaw's and Star Market Foundation Nourishing Neighbors Initiative will donate funds to end hunger here in our local communities. Since its inception, Nourishing Neighbors has raised more than $250 million across the country to ensure our neighbors have the nutrition needed to thrive. Locally, the Shaw's and Star Market Foundation will be enabling a donation of $100 every time we feed the puck for a goal to the Greater Boston Food Bank to help end hunger, up to $50,000. To learn more about Feed the Puck for Families, visit 985thesportshub.com/feedthepuck.
The Honda you want is here. Now is the perfect time to drive in the moment with the rugged and capable Ridgeline, Passport, and Pilot. Find your adventure with great offers now available on the Honda you want. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 2.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Passport or Ridgeline and a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Pilot.
See dealer for financing details.
A lot has changed since our start in 1960. Machines have gotten stronger, smaller, bigger, and smarter. With new technology, you can get to grade faster, hit your target payload the first time, and reduce the chance of accidents. But what hasn't changed is our commitment to you. At Milton Cat, our business is supporting your business with quality equipment, parts, and service. Visit MiltonCat.com today to learn why we've been the Northeast's trusted equipment dealer for over 60 years.
Introducing Sparked Energy at Dunkin', available in two delicious flavors, Berry Burst and Peach Sunshine. Drop by or order on the Dunkin' app today. Fruit flavored, contains 0% fruit juice. Caffeine from caffeine and guarana. Participation may vary. Limited time offer.
Hey, it's Maz for DraftKings, an action-packed fight card taking place in Las Vegas for UFC 300. And the DraftKings Sportsbook, the official sports betting partner of UFC, is giving you a chance to get in on the action with a knockout offer for every fight fan. New customers, if you bet on any UFC 300 bout, you can turn $5 into $150 instantly in bonus bets. From the much-anticipated title fight between Pereira versus Hill to the exciting undercard bouts, DraftKings is giving new customers a shot to rack up some bonus bets. Again, just lay down some action on any UFC 300 bet, and you'll get the bonus bets back instantly, no matter what. Just download the DraftKings Sportsbook app. The code is SportsHub, and again, new customers can bet $5 to get $150 instantly in bonus bets.
Hope is here. 800-327-5050 or gamblinghelplinema.org. Must be 21 plus. Play it smart from the start. GameSenseMA.com. Visit the president of Massachusetts. Bonus bets expire 168 hours after issuance. Eligibility and deposit restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.draftkings.com/MMA.
Listen live. Check out our podcast with the 98.5 The Sports Hub app.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the 98.5 The Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network.
Boston, the home of the Patriots, the South, the Rams, and the Bruins. Boston's home for sports is The Sports Hub, a Beasley Media Group station.
Pasternak pulls it free, back of the net. Slings it right circle. Shattenkirk shoots. He scores! Kevin Shattenkirk with a bullseye in the top far corner. 3-1 Bruins. That's our Bruins exceptional play presented by Timberline Construction, providing truly exceptional service in construction management, pre-construction, design, build, and due diligence support. Learn more at timberlineconstruction.com. Timberline Construction, exceptional, no exceptions. The Bruins with a 4-2 lead over the Penguins. Here as we hit the second intermission, the Bruins exploded for all four in that second period.
Yeah, I mean, well, they took advantage of, you know, Nedeljkovic wasn't great. He's made some good saves. He had made some good saves in this game, but he just never really looked all that comfortable, at least to me. And Mike Sullivan must have sensed something similar, because on the third goal, when Shattenkirk beat him clean from the right-wing circle, that's when he pulled him. But the prior goal, the one that, just before that, the goal by Zacha, that was a shot taken by Grizzlick from... It wasn't a great angle for Grizzlick. You know, he's outside... He's above the dot and outside the dot in the left-wing circle, and he risks this puck. It's a wrist shot towards the net, and Nedeljkovic, you know, makes the save, but it comes right to Zacha in the slot area, and Zacha just one-times it back home. And like, that one, to me, said, okay, you know, you can get to this guy here today. And because DeBrusque was a redirect, and then he had trouble with kind of locating. It was underneath him, and DeBrusque got his own rebound. But... I thought he fought the puck a couple times in the first period as well. So Jari comes in, and, you know, after the Penguins got away, Jari comes in. Now the Penguins are on a power play, and Jari goes back and plays a puck that was dumped in by the Bruins, plays it around the boards, and I don't know what Carlson's thinking here. It kind of goes back to the what we talked about in the pregame show. Congratulations on 1,000 games for Erik Karlsson, but sometimes he can be adventure in his own zone. I think he believes that he's got support up the boards. There's nobody there for the Penguins. So partly his fault, partly not his fault. Coyle just goes, gets the puck along the wall. Now where are all the Penguins? Well, no one's hustling back because Jari had the puck. So they're all kind of taking their time coming back. Coyle finds a guy wide open in front, Brad Marchand. There's no coverage at all. And he's all by himself. And the Penguins have the man advantage. Sullivan quickly makes a line change, get that group off the ice. Then he goes back to them. Later in the same power play, that's the goal by Bunting off the play from Malkin. It's one that Ullmark should have had. Ullmark's had a strong game here today. No chance on the goal by Rust, but he's had a strong game, but that's one that he would definitely like to have back. And that closes the gap to 4-2. So you've got four goals in this game. Normally, more than enough to win a hockey game if you're the Bruins and if you're playing with confidence. The Penguins have something going on for them right now. They got something kind of special in the way that they've played, the way that they've been able to battle. I'm not counting them out of this game. They've got too much firepower, especially on the top end, and the way that Crosby and the season that he's had. I don't count them out, so the Bruins have to have, you know, their best period here, I believe.
But tonight has been, at least to this point, the worst-case scenario for the Penguins.
It's been unbelievable as we've been watching it all unfold. So Detroit just won in overtime. It was a power play goal against the Toronto Maple Leafs. They had a power play going into overtime. And Larkin redirects one, so 2 points for Detroit. They end up now with 87 points. Philadelphia wins today. They have 87 points. Washington has 87 points. And Pittsburgh, as of right now, as of this second, going into the third period, trailing by two, they're out of the playoffs by 1 point. They have 86. Now, they do have a game in hand on Philly, but they're going to be even in games with Washington and Detroit. Pittsburgh does have the tiebreaker over those two teams. Of the three teams that have 87 points, Washington has the tiebreaker. So technically, Washington jumps into a playoff spot at this second. So, yeah, all the teams, you know, we've been laughing because some of the teams around that are trying to vibe for this this playoff spot, the Islanders have been hot, the Penguins have been hot, Washington, Philly, Detroit have been ice cold, and they all win today. So now things get even tighter here in this East, fighting for two playoff spots. The Islanders look to be comfortable because they got an extra point here this afternoon after they lost to the New York Rangers in a shootout. And they're at 90 points, so they still have a three-point cushion over the closest team chasing them.
And their last game is against the Pittsburgh Penguins. Yes. On a home ice. Scoring summary from that second period. Jake DeBrusque is 19th at 8:08, 1-0 Bruins. Pavel Zacha is 20th at 8:22, 2-0 Bruins. Brian Rust is 28th at 10:27, 2-1 Bruins. Kevin Shattenkirk is 6th at 11:35. The goaltending change was made. Brad Marchand scored shorthanded his 29th at 14:54, but Michael Bunting tallied on that power play his 19th to make it 4-2 Bruins at the end of two. Shots on goal in favor of the Penguins, 21-19. On the power play, the Bruins 0-1 and the Penguins 1-2. Music of the game is brought to you by Live Nation. Celebrate two of the most
most beloved albums of the 90s with Live and Stone Temple Pilots on September 5th at the Xfinity Center. Get tickets now at LiveNation.com. Beersy's going to update the full out-of-town NHL board when we return on the 98.5 The Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
It's Ford Truck Month. Are you ready? And we're celebrating 47 years as the best-selling trucks in America with special once-a-year offers on Ford F-Series. Are you ready? Featuring the new 2024 Ford F-150 and Ford Super Duty, the 2024 North American Truck of the Year. Celebrate with us, America. This is Ford Truck Month, based on 1977 to 2023 industry reported total sales.
98.5 The Sports Hub and the Bruins Radio Network welcome the following new partners. Shell and the Shell Fuel Rewards Program. Bruins fans save big on home game days. Save 25 cents per gallon on Shell V-Power Nitro Plus Premium Gasoline with the Fuel Rewards Program. Download the app and join the Fuel Rewards Program. And Nissan. At Nissan, they make cars that thrill. Experience the thrill for yourself today. Shop NissanUSA.com. From the home of the Bruins, thank you for joining our winning team.
Dunkin' is dropping a new kind of energy. Introducing Sparked Energy by Dunkin'. It's energy for the fun of it. Available in two full-on delicious flavors, Berry Burst and Peach Sunshine. It's what you need when your afternoon needs you to get going. A revitalizing burst of caffeine, vitamins, and minerals gives you the energy to turn the fun up to 11. True story. Drop by or order ahead on the Dunkin' app today. Fruit flavored. Contains 0% fruit juice. Caffeine from caffeine and guarana. Participation may vary. Limited time offer.
Need a new roof? It's East Coast Metal Roofing Spring into Savings Promotion. Reference me, Felger and Maz, or 98.5 The Sports Hub, and get 10% off your complete roof replacement. Visit eastcoastmetalroofing.com.
Join New Hampshire Liquor and Wine Outlet on a West Coast rendezvous during our Pacific Pour Savings event. Now through April 28th, save 20% off the purchase of 12 or more bottles of wine from Washington, Oregon, and California. Whether you savor the bold flavors of Washington, the crisp elegance of Oregon, or the sun-kissed richness of California, now is your chance to uncork the savings. For more info, visit liquorandwineoutlets.com. Discount valid on 375 and 750 milliliter size bottles only. Please drink responsibly.
The home of the Revs, the Sports Hub.
Back here in Pittsburgh at PPG Paints Arena. Bruins have a 4-2 lead over the Penguins after two periods of play. We take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. Wild day here in the NHL, especially here in the East. Rangers come out on top in a shootout, 3-2 winners over the New York Islanders. Dallas Stars 3-1 over the Seattle Kraken. Winnipeg over Colorado 7-0. That game was played in Colorado. Panthers 3, Sabres 2. That game decided in overtime. Washington beat the Tampa Bay Lightning 4-2. The Philadelphia Flyers with a 1-0 shutout over the New Jersey Devils. 5-4 Ottawa in a shootout over the Montreal Canadiens. Red Wings get the goal in overtime by Dylan Larkin. They beat the Maple Leafs by the score of 5-4. Third period action, the Nashville Predators with a 6-2 lead over the Columbus Blue Jackets. A couple other games later on today. A good one in Edmonton, the Vancouver Canucks in Edmonton to take on the Oilers. And it'll be the LA Kings hosting the Anaheim Ducks. And the Minnesota Wild will visit the San Jose Sharks. Here in Pittsburgh, the Bruins leading the Penguins 4-2 after two periods of play. Third period action coming up next on the 98.5 The Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealer.
If you need tires, think Town Fair Tire. Thinking name brands? We have them all. Thinking price? We beat the competitors. Free services? We have those too. For the guaranteed lowest price, nobody beats Town Fair Tire. Nobody.
Town Fair Tire. Until the speakers blew. Luckily, my new Nissan Sentra was just up the street. With its Bose audio system, I was able to get the party going again. And turn it all the way up.
Drive the Nissan Sentra. Now, get a low $229 per month lease for 36 months on the 2024 Nissan Sentra. Shop at your local Nissan store or at NissanUSA.com. Well-qualified lessees. 2024 Sentra S front-wheel drive.
$25.99 initial payment excludes tax, title, and license. Disposition fee due at lease end. Take from new dealer stock. Call 1-888-858-8319 for offer details. Ends 4/30/24.
The Stanley Cup Playoffs Bracket Challenge presented by Betway is back. And now it's time to take your shot. Face off against family and friends. And take aim at predicting this year's playoffs. Whether you're pulling for the Panthers, going big on the Blue Shirts, or seeing stars all the way, who do you think hoists the cup this year? Sign up today for a chance to win exclusive prizes at NHL.com/bracket.
Tito's Handmade Vodka on game day? Pour me in, coach. From a seat in the stands to the best seat on the couch, root for your favorite team with your favorite team spirit. No matter who's on your roster, lineup, or lucky jersey, make Tito's your first-round bottle pick. Whose house? Tito's house. Find cocktail recipes for every fan at Tito'sVodka.com. 40% alcohol by volume, namely 80 proof, crafted to be savored responsibly.
Hey, DQ fans, behold the DQ Freezer, holding all of the DQ Blizzard flavors of the past, like Fan Fave Frosted Animal Cookie and Legendary Brownie Batter, only at participating DQ locations. Happy tastes good.
It's only human to be passionate, loyal, and all in when it comes to the Bruins. And it's only human to expect the same from your bank. And just like every season, TD will be there for all the wins, losses, and memorable moments. Best of luck this season. TD Bank, the bank of the Boston Bruins. Member FDIC, TD Bank N.A.
Boston Bruins hockey is brought to you by Timberline Construction. Just like the pros, success in the commercial construction industry requires a strong, smart team with a no-exceptions commitment to excellence. That's why so many high-profile organizations choose Timberline Construction, specializing in ground-up projects, complex renovations, and projects with advanced technical requirements. Learn more at TimberlineConstruction.com. Timberline Construction. Exceptional. No exceptions.
The only place to hear the game, the Sports Hub.
Now it's time to look back at 100 years of Boston Bruins hockey, presented by Granite City Electric.
Back on the right side of the Schaefer fence, a shot at wide to the net, the rebound out in front, Sanford, and it is. And it's 2-0. Sanford picks up McHale's rebound, he bangs it in.
Tonight we remember Eddie Sanford, part of the legendary 100. Sanford spent 8 of his 9 seasons with the Bruins from 1947 to 1955. He made 5 consecutive All-Star appearances starting in 1951 and led all scorers with 8 goals and 11 points during the 1953 Stanley Cup playoffs. After Milt Schmidt retired, Sanford was named the Bruins captain. When his playing days were over, Sanford became an NHL off-ice official based out of Boston. He worked as a goal judge, official scorer, and supervisor of off-ice officials. And Sanford was also a longtime member of the Bruins alumni, and he helped found the organization along with Milt Schmidt. Sanford passed away October 23rd at age 95, just as the Bruins centennial season was getting started. That look back at 100 years of Bruins hockey was presented by Granite City Electric Supply, celebrating 100 years of service to electrical contractors and our communities throughout New England. Go to graniteCityElectric.com. Both teams back on the ice. We're about ready to start the third period here in Pittsburgh. Bruins working right to left. This is the start of their last road trip of the regular season. It'll end for the Bruins in Washington on Monday night. Duncan pregame at 6:30. The puck drop at 7 o'clock. The Bruins, one of the best road teams in the National Hockey League, at 22-8-9. Coyle, Marchand, DeBrusk will begin up front. Lindholm and Carlo on the back end. Sidney Crosby out with Brian Rust and Drew O'Connor to begin things for Mike Sullivan. The Penguins have fashioned 4 wins when they have trailed at the end of 40 minutes. They're 4-21-6.
They're taking a little different approach today than they did the other day against Detroit, right? They led them how many times in that game?
A ton. Wrister by Marchand, gobbled up by Jari. We've got to stop.
Coming back and mistakes by the Penguins, you know, allowed them to come back. take a little different approach to it today. Start with a two-goal deficit going into the third.
The Penguins in that game were up 1-0, 2-1, 4-2, and 5-3 in the third period. And they had to win it 6-5 in overtime. Erik Karlsson with a game winner. Sidney Crosby set it up with his 1,000th assist. That's 14th all time. Penguins win the draw. Pounded around to the far side. Zacha forces a turnover, but his pass in the middle picked off. And it's brought into the Bruins zone. The Bruins able to sweep it just barely out to center ice. Ooh, Pasternak took an awkward hit from Karlsson. Repositions the bucket. Karlsson brings it in, drops and drives. Sent toward the front of the net, and it's blockered over the glass by Ullmark.
Pasternak was looking for maybe a high stick penalty there on Karlsson. Inadvertent, but it looked like he might have got it up. He asked the referee what he thought.
Aceoff in the far circle of Bruins end. Charlie Coyle out there to take the draw. He'll go up against Crosby. Off the draw, Rust shoveled it around to the near side. At the right point, Pettersson pulled it off the wall. He'll bang it deep. Back of the net, Crosby took a check. And then it sent out in front. It ricocheted off some of the traffic, and Ullmark had to be alerted at the near post.
O'Connor was there.
And now here's Carlo. 4-on-2, the Bruins rush over the line. Here's Marchand to the right point. Darts to the right of the net. Backhand tried to pick the top corner near side, and Jari just got a piece of it and covers.
Crosby and McAvoy had gotten locked up behind the play there for a second or two. Couple chances for both teams, right? O'Connor was locked up in front with Brandon Carlo, and that puck ricocheted off of him. And the Bruins get going back up the other way. And Marchand ends up going into them deep in the right wing circle, tried to go short side high on Jari.
Marchand, by the way, that's his 29th goal of the season that he scored shorthanded. Bruins off the draw, power it to the right dot, and couldn't pass it to the middle, but it's held in for a second. The last time Marchand hit a 30-goal season, you have to go back to 21-22, as this puck is sent off the surface. He's had five different 30-goal seasons. 18:39 left here in the third. Bruins 4, Penguins 2. Jim Montgomery will throw Lauko, Geeky, and Frederick out there together. A little subtle change. Beecher had been on the left side on this line. Puck drilled up the middle, and the Bruins deflected at the blue line and paddle it out to the neutral zone. It's powered in by Letang. Took a hit from Lauko after he did. Out in the neutral zone, here's Frederick. Throws it in. Left corner chasing his Geeky along the near side. Bruins trying to dig it off the wall. Lauko at the near hash along with Frederick. Frederick looks left and right. He's surrounded by Raquel and Malkin. Back of the net it goes. It's Joseph. The Bruins will start to change. We've played 2 minutes here in the third. The Bruins up by two. Letang going laterally across his blue line. Saucers a pass to Carter. Shoots, and Ullmark deflects it with the stick over the glass.
That's Bruins Hockey. Is brought to you by Removal Pro of New England. If your home or office needs an oil tank removed or installed, call the experts at Removal Pro at 740-TANK-PRO. If it's big and heavy and it's got to go, call Removal Pro at 740-TANK-PRO. Online at oilremovalpro.com.
Jeff Carter will lean in for the draw in his 19th season in the NHL. Eighth among active players in goals, sixth in games played. The puck has sizzled just wide and won two Stanley Cups. He was a big player in that for the LA Kings. Far point, Carter. Shovel the backhand down low. It's tapped over to the near side. Boquist locates it. He'll wheel out to center ice. Right wing at the red line. Carlo will wrist it in. Took a funny hop. I think it hit Jari in the back of the head. Sent up to the right point. Here's Peak. Dusts it off. Now Maroon shoveled it back of the net. He had a great chance in the first period. Now Beecher swings it up top. Left point now. Shattenkirk throws it toward the front of the net. Deflected. And you had Jari moving and this puck sent wide. Maroon battles to try and keep it in, cannot, but flipped it back to Shattenkirk, his former Lightning teammate. Puck chipped into the right corner by Peak, and the Bruins change. We've played 3 minutes here in the third.
Bruins 4 and the Penguins 2. All the goals coming in the second period. Back of his net, St. Ivany. A dish to the far side. Shea back to St. Ivany. Off his skate. He'll scoot behind his net. Watched by Heinen. St. Ivany comes up the middle. Now fires it off a Bruin stick. It floats into the right corner. Pustin and sent it to the front of the net looking for Smith. He had a step. The Bruins break the other way. Here's Zacha. Speeds in. Pulls up at the near point. Slings it down low. Back of the net. Pettersson. Shoveled it over to the far side. It's given away. Left circle. Pastrnak walks in. Back of the net. Tripped up. We got a penalty. And the Bruins are going to the power play for only the second time tonight, leading 4-2.
Yeah, Pastrnak picks this puck up after the turnover by the Penguins, and he can take the shot right away if he wants to. He tries to make this move to his backhand. Then I think he was going to try to come back out in front. Pettersson slides to try to take it away from him, and even though he doesn't get the puck, he takes the feet with his feet, takes the feet out of Pastrnak. He's trying to protect the pass across. Heinen's on the far post, and Pastrnak's got a chance to get it to him. Pettersson slides and ends up tripping up David Pastrnak.
Faceoff in the left circle, the Penguins, and the Bruins had three shots but did not score on their first power play. They win another draw.
Didn't mind it, though.
Pastrnak to Zacha, shoots. Jarry the save. The rebound paddled away from Marchand at the last second after he gloved it down. Right point. Here's McAvoy. Wheels to the middle to Pastrnak up top. Far side now to Brusque. Dished at center point, McAvoy. Pastrnak, high slot. Right circle to Brusque. Saucered behind McAvoy. And back into the Bruins zone it goes. Penguins changed some of their penalty killers. Here's Pastrnak. He'll speed over the line right side. To the right hash. His pass up top. Corralled. McAvoy.
He wanted that one-timer there. Pass handcuffed him.
And now out at center ice, O'Connor gets around Marchand into the slot, shoots, he scores! What a move, and then he cranked it off the near post, a short-handed goal, Bruins 4, Penguins 3.
The Bruins come into the zone, try to go back to the point. They said McAvoy wanted the one-timer, handcuffs him, he tries to keep it in, can't. It's pushed up the ice, Marchand's back, but O'Connor chips this puck past Marchand. And what a shot to finish it up over the glove hand side of Linus Ullmark. What a finish. O'Connor's had himself a strong year, getting an elevated ice time, all situations. Makes this nice move around Marchand and is able to pound this puck home.
So after the Bruins gave up only two shorthanded goals in their first 78 games, they've allowed shorthanded goals in back-to-back contests. Over the line left side now, Heinen. Shot it out in front. Jarry the save. The rebound's available. And Geeky had a whack at it, and Jarry kept it out of there. And he covers up.
He's got Marchand. There was going to be a delayed penalty on Marchand. He's kind of bothering O'Connor, and O'Connor able to just get himself free, and that's a great finish. Puck got up in a hurry.
For O'Connor, goals in three straight games. He's got a career-high 16 goals and 32 points. Shattenkirk wheels to the middle center point. Takes a look to Geeky near side. Back to Shattenkirk. Shoots! And Jarry the save. The rebound to the far corner. Heinen, up top it comes. 45 seconds left in the power play. Far corner, Maroon's got it. He'll bat it to the right point, Shattenkirk. Short pass to Coyle. Right of the net, Coyle. Saucers, Geeky. Up top, Shattenkirk. Relays, Heinen. Dusts it off. Swings it across. The pass too soft. And now you got another chance. Here's Rust. Over the line with Carter. Far circle, shoots. Ullmark the save. There's a rebound. Shoveled back of the net. Now Shattenkirk up the middle. He'll wheel over the line left side. Maroon at the left point. Throws it high to the far corner. 10 seconds left on the power play. Far side, Boquist got knocked down by Joseph. Boquist takes exception. Held in at the far point by Lindholm. Wedged it to Boquist. Now Lindholm scrambles at the far half wall. Penguins back to full strength. Back of the net, Boquist. Bruins 4, Penguins 3. With 14 minutes to go here in the third. Carlo
Ripped it into the near corner. Around it comes. Boquist prevented from getting into the puck by Joseph. Now Beecher speeds in. And now a long breakaway pass picked off by Lindholm. But it's scooped up by St. Ivany. A headman pass. Eller pulls up. Send it out in front. Omark the stop on Smith. Backdoor at the far post. Now far point. Boosting it. Backhands to Smith. The puck is sent into the slot. Beecher dives to get it out. And now Frederick wheels over the line. 1-on-3. And he got locked up by Pettersson and pushed down. And Frederick takes exception as the puck is drifted out to center ice. The Bruins guilty of being offside. And we've got to stop. 13:17 left here in the third. Bruins 4 and the Penguins 3. On the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
Hey, it's Charlie Coyle. I've teamed with Unicare, Franklin Sports, and 98.5 The Sports Hub to encourage more Massachusetts youth to improve their mental health by engaging in physical activity. Franklin Sports will donate $15,000 in athletic equipment to help kids get out and play. Get details at 98.5thesportshub.com/firstresponders.
Sports don't get any tougher than hockey, and trucks don't get any tougher than Ford F-Series, F-150, and Super Duty. The trucks that move mountains also move parade floats and snowmobiles. With that versatility, it's no wonder Ford F-Series is the number one selling pickup for 47 years straight. Visit buyfordnow.com for great offers. Your New England Ford dealers, a proud partner of your Boston Bruins. Sales claim based on 1977 to 2023 CY total sales.
Hi, this is Jake DeBrusk, and I'm excited to team up with the Shaw's and Star Market Foundation and 98.5 The Sports Hub once again for Feeding the Puck for Families. Every time me or one of my teammates feeds the puck this season to help score a goal, the Shaw's and Star Market Foundation Nourishing Neighbors Initiative will donate funds to end hunger here in our local communities. Since its inception, Nourishing Neighbors has raised more than $250 million across the country to ensure our neighbors have the nutrition needed to thrive. Locally, the Shaw's and Star Market Foundation will be enabling a donation of $100 every time we feed the puck for a goal to the Greater Boston Food Bank to help end hunger, up to $50,000. To learn more about Feed the Puck for Families, visit 985thesportshub.com/feedthepuck.
Felger and Naz, afternoons 2 to 6 on the Sports Hub.
Charlie Coyle with the lone assist on the Bruins' last goal. That was the shorthanded strike by Brad Marchand. With that feed, the Shaw's and Star Market Foundation donates another $100 to the Greater Boston Food Bank to help fight food insecurity. Learn more about Feeding the Puck for Families at 98.5thesportshub.com/feedthepuck. Puck kicked into the near corner of the Penguins' end. 13 minutes to go here in the third. Bruins' lead has been trimmed to 4-3. Pasternak backhands right of the net. Zacha trying to shake free from Pettersson. Sends it out in front. Jari the stop on Pasternak. Rebound corralled by the Bruins. Zacha up top. Grizzly bangs it down low. Pasternak shakes around to check. And we're going to have a penalty here on Carlson.
What a save Jari just made, though. Zacha makes a great move down below the goal line to break free from a check, gain some separation. And as he's going behind the net, he throws it back out short side. And Pasternak's right there, and it's a right pad save made by Jari. And then eventually Pasternak makes this move over on the left side. And the Bruins are going to make a little bit of a change here with their top unit. Kevin Shattenkirk's going to come out in place of Charlie McAvoy on the point.
Face off in the left circle of Penguins' end. For the Bruins, this is their third chance on the power play. On their last one, they allowed a shorthanded goal. Off the draw, the Penguins have it. Rim it around, and down it goes. 12:44 left here in the third. Bruins 4, Penguins 3. The Bruins' magic number to clinch the Atlantic Division still stuck at 4. Bruins have only 2 more games remaining after tonight. And the Panthers won earlier today in overtime over the Sabres. Shattenkirk settles it up top. Dusts it off. Shoots deflected over the crossbar by Zacha. Pettersson back of the net. Nowhere to go with the puck. Bruins bank it up top. Shattenkirk flings to the far side. Marchand. To Zacha, protects, get away from Letang.
What a game Zacha's had today.
High slot, now Pasternak shoots wide, he blistered it, and around the boards and down it goes.
Finally got free for that shot, and we haven't seen a lot of that here in recent games. You know, that one-timer from the left wing side, but Zacha makes a good play. Marchand makes a good play.
Zacha over the line of the left point. Now DeBrus skates to the hash marks, bumped it back to the near point. Pasternak holds and looks. Bumped up top, Shattenkirk looking for Pasternak. Tripped up. We play on. Far side, Marchand sent it right of the net looking for DeBrus. He opened the scoring for the Bruins. Nice play to muscle it to the far side, but the pass handcuffed one of the Bruins, and here's Carter on the rush, out of the line, into the far circle. Shoots Olmark, shut the five hole, and holds.
Yeah, they kept Carter outside the dot that time. He's a right shot coming down the left wing side. Still a dangerous shooter, but Olmark able to make a pretty routine save there, making sure, but nothing's routine right now, right? Not at this juncture of the game. And what's at stake for the Pittsburgh Penguins?
36 seconds remaining in the Bruins' power play.
I mean, the Bruins were back there. They had three guys back. That kept Carter to the outside. It was not an odd man rush.
So now McAvoy is back on, but he's with the second unit for the time being. Here's Heinen. Sends it through the middle. Geeky powers his way over the line, right of the net. Coyle centered. It got denied. The Penguins trying to flip it around to the near side. This won't get out. Maroon up top. Oh.
Maroon's a long way from the net.
Right circle. Coyle shoots. Maroon looking for a rebound. That was closer, and it just hopped away from him, and it's cleared down.
After he rotated from the blue line, he got down to the front of the net. Coyle had the initial shot.
Geeky motors in. Gets a return feed from Maroon. Penguins back to full strength. Maroon left corner. Up top, the pass missed everybody, and down it goes. Allmark set it up near circle for Lindholm. 10:40 remaining here in the third. Bruins on top 4-3 in Pittsburgh. We have an offside here on the Bees.
Check out the hardest working player of the week content on 98.5thesportshub.com, brought to you by the Peterson School. Are you a master in your trade and interested in passing the torch to the next generation of tradespeople? Join the growing team of instructors at the Peterson School. Visit petersonschool.com to learn more.
Faceoff in front of the Penguins bench.
Exciting game, Judd. I know there's a lot on the line. There's a lot of these games here today around the league.
And this is when hockey's at its best. Urgency, desperation, emotion. Oh. Along the near side, Lindholm stepped up, created a turnover. He'll push it deep. Frederick trudging after it. He's locked up with Joseph. They jam against the wall. It squirts out in front. Boquist fires. Jari the save. Rebound shoveled wide by Lauko.
Boy, he's made some big saves. Jari has to keep this game at one.
Frederick
one
near side. Frederick along the near wall. Think about the stop he made on Boquist at the tail end of the second. Here's Bunting. He'll wheel center circle. Over the line right side to Crosby. Throws it out in front. Bunting couldn't get a hold of it. Grabbed by Carlo. He'll flip it up the middle and out to center ice. And it's drilled by Frederick on net. Jari gloves, puts it down. Both teams change. Here's Letang up the middle. Feeds to the left side out at center ice. Pettersson angled in by Pustinen. Olmark stays in the net as the Bruins guided along the near side. It was knocked down in the corner by Eller. Eller pushed off the puck by Coyle. And along the near side, dug free by Marchand. Took a hit, made the play, got it out. Pettersson, under pressure from DeBrusk, sent it in front of his net. Letang returns, too far for Pettersson. Peak at the red line, hammers it in. Near side, Marchand scored a shorthanded goal, which right now serves as the game winner. If it stands like this, with 9 minutes to go here in regulation, Bruins completing some changes. The Zacha line comes out. Letang up the left side. Pettersson up left wing, deflected in deep by O'Connor. He scored shorthanded this period.
Nice one.
Bruins dust the puck behind their net. Here's Lindholm. Banked it up the left side. This will go off Carlson's stick all the way down. Along the near wall. Pulled out by Rust. Gave it away. Zacha kicked it into the far corner. He got locked up with Rust. Zacha with a goal and an assist today. Right circle, Pasternak. Thought about shooting it up top. Carlo shoots, and it's kicked out by Jari. That had a little sink to it. Back of the net. It's grabbed by Carlson. He'll motor up the middle. Carlson over the red line. Tonight playing in his 1,000th game. And the rebound off the end boards, gloved by Olmark. He'll take a draw, and we'll take a break. 8:14 left here in regulation. Bruins 4, Penguins 3 on the 98.5 The Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
The Honda you want is here. Drive in the moment. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 2.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Passport or Ridgeline and a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Pilot.
See dealer for financing details.
Download free nugs. Just add the Wendy's app to your phone and get an offer for a free 10-piece with purchase. Ah, yep, it's raining nugs again. One app, all the... Ow! Wendy's.
Limited time at participating Wendy's. New Year's is only. Account registration required. Terms apply.
If you're in the market for a great deal on Toyo tires, get to Town Fair Tire for your absolute best deal. Because at Town Fair Tire, you get the guaranteed lowest price on any Toyo tire. Plus, you get free services for life. And we honor all valid Toyo tire rebates. For the absolute best deal on Toyo tires, get to Town Fair Tire. Because nobody beats a Town Fair Tire deal. And I mean nobody.
Name brands at discount prices. Town Fair Tire.
A lot has changed since our start in 1960. But what hasn't changed is our commitment to you. Visit MiltonCat.com today to learn why we've been the Northeast's trusted equipment dealer for over 60 years.
Honda you want is here. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Accord and a 2.9% APR on a 2024 CR-V. So hurry into your local Honda dealer today.
See dealer for financing details.
The home of the bees, the Sports Hub.
The Boston Bruins Foundation Centennial Charity Bags presented by Demand Science are still available to purchase. These limited edition bags give fans the opportunity to own a unique collection of centennial-themed memorabilia, autographed items, and more. All proceeds benefit the Boston Bruins Foundation. Secure yours today by visiting bostonbruins.com/charitybags. John Beecher out for the draw in the near circle with Boquist and Maroon for this D-zone draw. Beecher will take it against Malkin. Bruins up by one with 8:14 left in regulation. Penguins win the faceoff. Letang bumps it between his legs to Joseph. Across, Letang, left point. Up top, Joseph shoots. Blocked, rebound out in front. Never got to Omar, who was going right to left. Now Joseph to Malkin near side. Sent it up top. Joseph, rink wide. Letang drilled it across. Up top now, Malkin. Letang, here it comes. Omar got a little bit of the glove as that skittered wide. Now Letang shoots, and that's deflected off the back glass. Boquist gets it out, and the Penguins will look to reload. Brought in by Raquel, shoots, blocked. Rebound near side. Boquist trying to dig it free, and it out. Skips by Letang and out to center ice.
Started with the faceoff win by the Penguins, and then full control against that line.
Carlson in the right corner, rims it around. Geeky's there. He'll bump it up the right side. Got interfered with by Rust.
You're not going to get this, that call right now. So.
And this puck is sent off the surface.
No, that's a good play by Rust. But, yeah, it all starts off the faceoff loss, right? And then Malkin wins the draw. They've got full possession of the puck in the offensive zone. It's Beecher, Boquist, and Maroon. And Maroon got isolated down low. He started out high, but then he got isolated down low trying to help push the front of the net out of, you know, get people out of, allow Omar to see the shot coming in. A couple of bombs from that left circle.
Here's to Brusque. He'll snap it into the right corner. Round it comes. Marchand chasing near side. Flip by him, and Rust will poke it back into the Bruins zone. Carlo's on it. Leaves it along the near wall for Lindholm. So Lindholm and Carlo playing together right now. Along the near side, Crosby. Sweeps back of the net. Far circle, the shot fanned on, and the Bruins with a 3-on-1. They lose the puck out at center ice.
I think Marchand took his eyes off of it.
Now countering. Here's Rush to the right circle. Sent it out in front. Deflected wide as Omar got knocked down. And the puck out to the neutral zone. Here's Marchand over the line left side. Marchand, with his team changing, protects the puck.
Crosby was going through the crease and wiped out Omar as he was looking for the pass.
I'd like to see a replay on that one, yeah. And we have an offside here on the Bruins. 6:27 left here
about,
in regulation.
4-3
Bruins.
Grizzlick trying to shake something off there as well. Yeah, Omark was out at the top of his crease. Crosby's actually going backwards looking for this pass coming from the right wing side. And Omark got wiped out, but Crosby doesn't know. He's not going through the crease.
But is Allmark in the blue paint when he gets
No, I'm saying I don't think he was. I think he was outside of it.
Back of the Penguins net, here's Letang.
No, he was in the blue paint. Just had a replay.
If that were another player, I think you may have seen a call.
Well, yeah.
There was some heavy contact there.
Two penalties earlier in the period. He might have had it too.
Bruins wedge it free. Frederick bounced it ahead. It was held in, then the Bruins snap it back out to the neutral zone. Here's Frederick, motors around a pick to the near side. Bruins up 4-3. Back of the net, Lauko centered, they score! Lauko to Geeky, he goes top shelf over the glove and Ajari. 5-3 Bruins.
Well, Frederick helps make this play as well. The Bruins win a battle inside their own zone. They're going to come out with it. Frederick up, gets his pass from Shattenkirk, comes up the left wing side. He's got a couple Penguins on him. He's going to pull up and then send this puck down below the goal line around the net. And Lauko's the first man on it. And a quick centering pass to Geeky. And Geeky on his forehand, quick release, doesn't dust it off, doesn't stop it. A little quick one-timer. Snapshot up and over top of the glove-hand side of Jari.
For Geeky, that's his 17th of the season. His previous career high set last year was 9. Pasternak brings it in. Bunting tries to strip him of the puck. Bruins protected along the far side. Bruins back up by 2 with 5.5 minutes left, but the Penguins have not gone away all night.
Oh, no.
Bruins were up 2-0 and 4-1. Brought in by Carlson. High slot Malkin. Sent back of the net. Out of the near corner. Along the near side, it's Malkin up top. Tapped away by Heinen. A foot race. Here's Pastrnak wheeling in, looking for his 48. Shoots, and he sent it just wide of the far post.
He tried to go high glove.
Out in front, Marchand, a backhand just wide.
Wide open.
Oh, right of the net, Marchand. Far circle.
Oh, he's had a couple of these pucks roll off his stick in this period. He was wide open again in front.
Bruins slinging up the left side. Coyle chases in the near circle. 5-3 Bruins. 4:45 left. Near circle, Letang. Cuts in front of his net. He'll now gather some speed. Feeds it to the left side. Joseph bounced to the right corner. Rust back of the net. Trying to bank it in, and Allmark shielded the near post. Now Coyle going to whack the puck out. One of the Penguins lost a stick. That's O'Connor back of the net. It's Crosby, sets up, banks it out in front, and the Bruins have it. They'll rush the other way. Here's DeBrusk. He'll speed over the line.
By himself, though.
Right circle. Tries to cut through the triangle. Goes back of the net. His team changing. Here's Boqvist. Right circle. Centered. Beecher all by himself. Backhand just wide.
How many times are guys just wide open in front?
Wow. DeBrusk trying to throw a puck back up top. It's Boqvist. Off the wall, rink wide. Here's Grizzlick to the dot, shoots, blocked, rebound, off Crosby and just wide.
I think that shot actually hit Beecher on the way in.
3:45 left here in the third. And the fans here have gone quiet. The Bruins up 5-3 on Geeky 17 from Lauko and Frederick.
3.5 minutes, keeping an eye on Jari right now.
Puck in the near corner in the Bruins zone. Maroon crashes in with a hit, and the Bruins shoveling up the left side. This puck gets out. Here's Pettersson, settles it near corner. Swings it up right wing, St. Ivany. Relays up the right side for Smith. It's drilled deep, Allmark back of the net. Peak stops it, plays it high off the glass, and it goes over into the netting. 3:12 left here in the third. Bruins 5 and the Penguins 3 on the 98.5, the Sports Hub Bruins Radio Network, driven by the versatile Honda CR-V at your local New England Honda dealers.
Honda you want is here. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Civic or HR-V. So hurry into your local Honda dealer today.
See dealer for financing details. Exclude Civic Si and Type R.
Bosch tools are built for workers. Bosch's powerful hammer drill has kickback control to help work go more smoothly when you need it. The 2-in-1 impact driver and wrench quickly changes between bits and sockets, so you only need one tool instead of two. And the X-Lock grinder switches wheels up to 5 times faster than standard grinders. Bosch tools take care of the job and you. Bosch tools, what hard workers deserve. Learn more at BoschTools.com.
Hi, I'm Patrice Bergeron, proud captain of Vivian DeBanks' Assist for Kids campaign to benefit Metro West Youth Hockey. I loved playing hockey growing up, so I'm excited to help more kids be able to play hockey.
And I'm Rob Cazone, president and CEO of Vivian Bank. For every Boston assist this season, we'll donate $50 up to $30,000. And Patrice will donate $7,000, giving us $37,000 to help even more Metro West youth hockey families.
Hey, Rob, I'm glad to help. Vivian DeBank, honest to goodness.
Get details at AvidiaBank.com/Team Bergeron. Member FDIC, member DIF.
The Honda you want is here, so bring on the fun. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR on a 2024 Honda Accord Hybrid or CR-V Hybrid. Hurry into your local Honda dealer today.
See dealer for financing details.
Connect with Buston's home for sports online. 98.5thesportshub.com.
Chris Tajari off for the extra attacker. So it'll be a 6-on-5 with 3:12 remaining in regulation. The Bruins up 5-3. Face-off right circle, the Bruins end, which is to our right. Pavel Zacha's going to lean in and take the draw.
That's Crosby.
Crosby has won 7 face-offs, lost 10. This one he wins. Near side, the Bruins trying to dig it free. Thrown to the front, and Omar skillfully played it to the far side. Pasternak, a long wrister, cut off by Malkin at his own blue line. Puck thrown just over the line near side by Crosby. He's knotted up by Zacha. They still battle for the puck, pulled out of there by Carlson. Poke check free, sent over the line left side. Here's Heinen. Shoots, he scores! He looked to the middle for Pasternak. The lane wasn't there. He snapped it in against his old team. An empty netter, his 17th. Bruins 6, Penguins 3.
Yeah, but Pasternak helped get that puck to him over on the left wing side. And Heinen, really good poise right there. The Bruins win a battle right at the blue line. Carlson pulls it off. It's Heinen's stick that pokes it free from Carlson to Pasternak in the middle. Carlson's going to cut Pasternak off, but Pasternak just lightly throws this puck over to the left wing, and there's Dan Heinen with the empty netter. Poise, composure, and finishes it off perfectly. 6 different goal scorers for the Bruins today. Heading to the exits here in Pittsburgh.
Jari back in net to our left. 2:47 remaining in regulation. Bruins win the draw. Hackett up the near side. Here's Pustinen. Flipped it along the near side. Eller back into the slot. Pustinen ripped it wide. Back of the net. Grizzlick traps the puck. Smith tries to pull it free from him. McAvoy kicking at it. Up to the left point. Now to the right point. St. Ivany bobbled it. Out to center ice it comes. 2:17 remaining here in regulation. Bruins 6. And the Penguins 3. The Penguins close to 4-3 with a shorthanded goal in this third period. And then the Bruins got the next two, including a huge marker from Morgan Geeky. Near circle of his own zone, Shea. He'll dart behind the net. Left it back there for St. Ivany. He'll skate it up the left side. The rookie defenseman banked it ahead a little too far for Zahorna. Set up by Omar. Play to the far side. And you can hear the Bruins fans in the building.
Haven't heard them because, usually we got a ton of Bruins fans. It's hard to tell who they are because there's a lot of people wearing the same colors here.
Pettersson wings it in off a leg. Allmark traps it. He'll cover it with a minute 29 left.
Hockey season is Peerless Boiler season. Replace your old boiler and water heater with a new Peerless Boiler and Pavilion tankless water heater. Find your local dealer at PeerlessBoilers.com. And remember, Peerless Boilers, the world's best-built boilers.
Faceoff in the right circle of Penguins' end. So the Bruins are on the verge of taking 2 of 3 in the season series against the Penguins, which includes winning the last two. And in the three games, If you add it up, the Bruins have now scored 16 goals against the Penguins. They score in the slot. Michael Bunting drills it by Omark. It's 6-4 now.
Well, Bunting was left alone there in the slot area that time, and Pittsburgh gains possession of this puck. Rotated from right to left out at the point. Just a breakdown in coverage, and I think Johnny Beecher would like to have that one back.
Well, now are we going to see Jari get pulled again? There's a minute 21 left. It's a two-goal game. Jari's on the ice right now. 6-4 Bruins. Bruins flip it over to the far side. DeBrusk shovels it in. Now the Penguins scoop it up. Jari looking to the bench. Here he comes. Puck fired in. 6-4 Bruins with a minute 7 left. The Bruins swing it over to the near side. Lauko turns, forehands it up the middle, back into the Penguins' end.
Good touch there.
1 minute to go. He was watching Scotty Scheffler. Up the middle, here's Carlson. Looks left, feeds left. Over the line, Malkin cuts to the slot. Bruins get a stick on it. It's flipped up the left side, out to center ice. Boquist tripped up on left wing. Here's DeBrusk, shoots just wide.
He can't believe it.
He was looking for his 20th. Bruins get it back.
He cannot believe it.
Carlo, 30 seconds left. Drills it up the right side. This is deflected off the surface by the high stick of Crosby with 29 and a half seconds remaining.
Jake wears it, you know. When he's disgusted with himself, he wears it, and he's wearing it right there. I'm sorry. I'm not making fun of him. It's just his body language after missing the net, and it's an open net. And he's in the zone. He just can't believe he missed that net.
Puck sent just inside the Bruins line. Marchand tripped up. He'll flip it out.
If it had been a one-goal game, it'd be... You wouldn't hear me laughing, but...
Back of the net, peak. 15 seconds left. Crosby had it pulled free. Marchand ripped it up the middle all the way down, just wide. The Penguins scoot back. This is icing with 8 seconds left, and yeah, the Bruins up by two.
So just looking at the Penguins' schedule, they've got Nashville on Monday, and then Wednesday against the Islanders, and that could be for the playoffs. The Islanders are probably in, but you never know. I know that the Flyers have to play the Capitals last game of the season, and all these teams battling it out. The Penguins started in the second wild card position, up on everybody. They've watched three teams pass them here today.
Faceoff in the right circle of Bruins' end. Eller will take it against Coyle. Eller wins it up top. Pastrnak trying to get it out. The Bruins wedge it up the middle with four. Here's Pastrnak coming in, tees it up, fires, and Jari the save, who came back in net as Pastrnak was denied, but this baby is in the books. The Boston Bruins are back into the top spot in the Atlantic Division. They've got a one-point lead over the Florida Panthers with two games left.
I'm gonna tell you a story.